And also, it was offline. You know, offline, you can do what you want. So that's the rule. Okay, with that out of the way, let's see how it gone, how it went, how it was. I don't know English. Also, let me know at any point if the sound is too quiet so I can up it a bit. And yeah. So my PB is 3 hours, 10 minutes, and 24 seconds. Whether it's new PB or not, we don't know yet. Let's just see. You know, let's just look at it. Sounds good, okay. Hey, hello everyone. I can say hi to everybody personally because, you know, a lot of people in the chat. But yeah. So, you know, as always with the runs, all the runs start in King's Pass. And the King's Pass, as we all know, will determine whether your run will be good or not. Because, you know, with bad King's Pass, there couldn't be a good run. And as you can see, the Vengefly was in a very bad spot, so obviously the run won't be good. And might as well reset right here. But we are very, you know, stubborn, so we keep going. Oh no. About to pull reverse nerf and make you think that it's pre-recorded while it's actually live. Well, with that out of the way, you see? Not really. It is actually pre-recorded. So yeah. It is indeed a run that I tried to get yesterday. Now you see how it goes. PB I'm running against has the best overworld, well, known to this day. And it was 40 seconds behind at some point against my previous PB. So this overworld is not that good. It's like late 225, you know. And we see if we can match it. Recently, I've been having very bad early games because I just never bothered with it. But by looking at, you know, at Kuro, at Blue, I've definitely noticed, I couldn't notice that my early game lacking quite a bit, you know. I can be like easy like 20, 25, 30 seconds behind by the time I get dive. So yesterday I actually practiced early game. Can you believe that? 112% runner practices early game. Just like some fucking any percent pleb. I'm sick of myself. But yeah, this is what you have to do sometimes. The webcam is AI generated, true. Hello, Rixian. And yeah. Decent grass game. Like, it's very hard to commentate the like early game because nothing really happens here. And you've seen it 20,000 times. There is hard to say anything, but I'm sitting on the bouncy ball, yes, as usual. I like my bouncy ball. Yeah, Rix is a paid artist. It's all staged. I hope I said it at the right time. Yeah, so let's talk about my previous run, or I guess my previous attempts. As you might know, I was away for like over 3 months. You know, like escaping from the war and all that, you know, like other bullshit. And I've been quite salty about it because, you know, people have been hyping 309 a lot. Like, oh my god, 309, the last 10 minute barrier to be broken. And I was always saying, not only me, by the way, but I also was saying that 309 is nothing special. It's like something I should have had like months ago. but I had to stop playing the game because of IRL reasons, and now I'm back. As salty as I ever was. And angry at everybody. So yeah, here we go. And my Duras policy is I try to finish every run I start. You know, unless it's too traumatic, I guess, but my first ever finished run after comeback was 6 minutes behind my actual PB. So as you see, my pain points are quite high. I can like finish runs that are minutes ahead with, you know, multiple deaths. And I mean, it's bouncy ball. Do you expect me to be static? Do I bother people with ADHD? Is it too annoying?
Run on in, man.
Yeah, getting the core workout. Like, after sitting on this bouncy ball for like 3 hours straight, I can't feel my back, you know? Like, I'm standing up and almost like falling down because I just can't stand. Yeah, I game on bouncy ball a lot. I game on bouncy ball, I work on... I don't have a chair. So, you know... I moved and I still haven't bought a chair. I use like a fucking kitchen chair when I just sit on the chair. And bouncing ball acts as a chair replacement for me. But yeah, as you can see, 501 Vengeful Spirit, this is quite good, you know. By the way, hey Isaac, hello. Like, yeah, 501 Vengeful Spirit is quite alright. You can already see that my early game starts showing, because this is my first 501 since I came back. I was having like 508, 505, like, my best was I think 503 with, you know, like the best possible RNG. And this was nothing special, but I still got 501. So yeah. Practice an early game actually improves early game. Who would have fucking thought? Yeah. I was inspired, you know, by good early game runners and, you know, by Prolog ILs I've witnessed on Celeste channels. Yeah. Mm. So let's see. I got first speed, I think, right? I think it was first speed. So let's see what we gotta get. Well, it's not first, but I mean second speed, and with the third for the fireball skip is very good. So let's see if I still got this. Yes, no. 1-2-2-1 muscle memory will never be erased for me. thanks, Kyle. And we are 5 seconds ahead. This is my first 653 since I came back. First 653 is actually my best green path entrance ever. Which is quite stupid because, you know, like, blue gets 51s quite regularly when he gets like a double first speed or something. This wasn't the first speed though, so 653 is definitely a good time for the RNG I gotten. This is a pre-recorded attempt that I did yesterday, yes. So far, very clean green path. I'm not stopping for that fly. You see how close I am, and I collected 6 Geo. That was like pretty clean execution too. The second fireball skip, you can see I got on the Coyote frames because of the scuffed jump animation. And so this is like... this is something I don't like. This frame perfect frame decal or whatever. It messes up with your visual cues a lot, because here you have to, like, you see, you have to stay on a certain spot for this trick to work, for this Moss Knight double to work. But this fucking thing just covers your sight. And then you have to do the Vengefly King at 1 HP. And this is just, like, so bad. I think it's just got fixed on 1.5 family. So I decided to get into Fury here because I didn't get it early. So 7 Geo flew away, like 6 or 7 Geo flew away, which is quite bad. Like the Geo in this route I'm doing is really tight up until Colo, up until buying Colo. So you kind of have to be aware of it. So you can see I'm kind of clipping the corner here just to collect one. That was not actually on purpose. And this, what you can do here is you can kill the most charger late so you don't get knockback. But I went for knockback intentionally to collect as much Geo as I can. And I lost, like, it lost like 0.3 or 0.5, I don't remember. Oh yeah, yeah, I will definitely describe some things I missed, like some things I didn't go for, brain farts and all that. This run is quite eventful, let me tell you, you know. This is something I started going for. So I've been practicing early game, been labbing Cornet 1, and I've labbed out that, at least for me, I get faster fights if I start with an up slash nail cancel. So what usually see runners do here is up slash, side slash, side slash. And I found that up slash fireball and then two side slashes, it just doesn't hurt. The only thing you need to be aware of is that you don't do nail cancel too fast because then Horn will iframe your fireball. But otherwise, I can't see any downsides of doing that, at least in 112%. And it like speeds up stagger count and all that, and you always have soul for that, like after killing Moss Knight. Moss Charger and Moss Knight, yeah. Somebody typed exclamation mark PB, I was ready for that. Yeah, I practiced this too, so I tried to do like a good... You see, I got this skill ceiling. Ceiling boost, but I did not land on the ledge because I got it way too good. So I just flew past the ledge and took a hard fall. Skill ceiling boost, yeah. Skill ceiling boost is when Hollow Knight runners switch to Celeste for some amount of time and then come back. As practice shows, it definitely increases the skill ceiling. A bit scuffed. Shroom fights. That room, like that particular room, makes nail cancels slower. So in 1-2-1, you barely can do any nail cancels at all in that room, and on 1.5, nail cancels just slow down. For some reason, I don't know why. I don't know what's about that room, but this room really lacks your nail cancels, and that's why you see runners miss them all the time in this room. And on 1-2-1, runners will just not go for them, like just straight not go for them. And yeah, I've been messing up explosion pogo, so I've practiced that as well. Of course, I'm getting it first try here. Like, you can definitely see how this early game is way cleaner than I normally would get. It's as if it's not me playing at all. So my best, I had to do the second here just for safety, and I do this nail hit just like, you know, based any percent runners do, because I want to be like them, you know, like people with actually good movement in this game. And yeah, you kind of see the green here, because in my PB I was like minus 12, minus 15, plus 12 or plus 15, because I'm rusty. I'm not gonna run Celeste, no, that game is bad because it doesn't have RNG, and I can't blame the game. And I would never run the game that I can't blame. This is like too like some kind of movement. I love just cool pogo, and I actually know if it's fast. It's just something that aligns well and I just do it. Yeah, and so my best city gate is 1305. It's just my, it's like my best city gate ever. And I think I'm about to beat it, finally. Like, 1305 is bad city gate time. Like, you know, Kuroshi94 would get 1305 and he would like cringe, like, ugh, bad early game. And I was, what the fuck, it's my best one. Like, fuck you. So it made me ashamed of myself, so I won't actually practice this entire section. I've unironically did City Gate ILs, like, from Vengeful Spirit to City Gates. Like, what the fuck? Yeah. So, as you can see, 13 flat. This is better than my best City Gate ever. So this is my best City Gate ever now. This is also a cool piece of movement that I do here. You just up slash pogo him and then grab the wall to avoid hard fall, and you just fall straight down. I really like this piece of movement. And yeah, this little, you can get ceiling boost here too if you pogo the bench precisely. There's actually like especially in early game when you don't have wings and all that stuff, there's so many like these little movement optimizations, like ceiling boosts, like buffer dashes, like pogos into something that you can abuse to your advantage and that many people will not even notice. Unless you run this game a lot and you just know what happens. Like, for example, here I lost some time by dropping down the ledge. It's like 0.3. If you pogo him a little bit later, you will just fall straight down into the transition and save a little bit of time. So, and that's where the early game time safely comes from. Here you can do one less dash, but I started doing that just for consistency because doing two dashes I would get hit often. And getting hit on this section is quite annoying. We don't know Hex, we're gonna see that. Hey Jax. Mandatory 3 slashes on the wall. And pogo on the on the lever. Yeah, and also Sanctum is approaching. Recently I've been like so consistent. It seems like Soul Sanctum just finally clicked to me, you know? I just never die here anymore. Like, whatever happens, I can just do it. And the strats I'm doing here, they called safetymizations. Well, unfortunate bonk. But yeah, you see, we're already like 20 seconds ahead. So you try to stay closer to... you see, I could have dashed straight through. Like, I could have pogo dash instantly, but I delayed my dash just a little bit to see where they spawn, because I went into the spawn trigger and then observed the spawn positions first, because making the move. Otherwise, what you can do is you can, like, just dash into the enemy. And here, I try to align doubles, and you see I get them a lot. Basically, I delay my fireballs just a little bit to see if he steps back. If he steps back, I try to shoot instantly, so he gets a double. Of course, it doesn't always work, but I really try to be conscious about this fight, because the faster it ends, the less damage you will take, and the more time you will save. That room was pretty smooth, too. And here, you see, I hugged the wall. I always hug this wall, because then you have time to either dash right away, or drop on the ground and dash under, if like the guy spawns. I shot the second one just in case, because what you usually see is like you will shoot your fireball and you see and you hear like a couple kills, like there are five falls, and if you hear five hits, you're alright. But since they grouped together, I didn't hear it, so I shot twice. And you see the first brain fart, I forgot to take Fury, and here, yeah. This is the brain fart. I literally forgot to get to Fury. So my genius plan is like, okay, I will damage tank on the first phase to get in Fury. And you see me damage tank in here. I try to go really aggressively to get hit, and I can't get hit. So I start jumping. Like, you like, hit me. And I try to get hit for Fury, but I just cannot. And here, okay, the first hit. Here's the second hit. So that was intentionally. That was intentional. I try to get into Fury to get at least a little bit of a time save. You see how slow this fight is without Fury. I've timed this fight to save like 11 seconds. 11 seconds to Fury on average. On average. Not even optimally. So yeah, I'm losing like a fuck ton of time here. Like, it was really, really slow fight. So yeah, and the second fight, I think this is the worst pattern. Yeah, this is the worst pattern because he just always dives. And you kill him in the air, so this is really slow. And look at the time loss. I'm losing 20 seconds to my gold. And if not for the Fury second phase, I would have lost like 25, I'm not joking. So at least I got, you know, at least I didn't lose as much time as I can. So this is the brain fart, this is like a real brain fart. Yeah, here I think, yeah, here I couldn't dive in a way to fucking fake dive, I forgot about it. Yeah, yeah, so on this patch you can just get consistent fake dives. And you see I'm out of soul, so I have to do this, I have to annoyingly stay there and wait for the fucking soul to get, to gather to the dive. Second brain fart. So you see how this, like, how this run already kind of falls apart. And in situations like that, especially in the long categories, what you have to do is, you know, you have to calm yourself down, because this is a long category, stuff like that will happen. Like, it is impossible to play like 3.5 hours consistently good, so you just have to accept that shit like that will happen at some point, and you just have to deal with it. Don't like throw a tantrum or lose your shit, just go on, it's okay. Yeah, yeah, Violet, like 1738 dive. Like, without early most night, it's like 1725, which is like, maybe like 2028. So it's like give or take, it's like give or take like 10 seconds. Reverse nerf. Like this. Yeah, this is a very consistent movement. If you don't fuck it up, you will always be able to dodge all patterns. Like, this is annoying. So what I go for, I go for early control here. So my idea is that I will pick the key up and the guy with the sword hits me. But sometimes he just jumps away from you and you have to wait the full animation. So a little bit of an RNG time loss there, unfortunately. Yeah, I'm sitting on the ball. So another time loss. How feels make runes runs without chat? Hey Martindal. I mean, so I play way better offline because I can focus on the run actually and don't talk with the chat, to the chat. So playing online lets me focus on an actual run and not on the chat. So I make less mistakes. And I'm also more calm when I play offline, because I know that there aren't like people watching, so I definitely feel differently when people are watching me play. That's for sure. It's, you know, sometimes it's for better because it makes things more hype, but sometimes it's for worse because it is distracting and it's just, you know, the herd feeling, like herd, like a sheep herd. Like look when somebody is around. Like, you don't react to things the same way when you are alone than when you're in a group of people. It's just how human works. So yeah. Crystal pick. Good RNG here, which is always welcome. Bad RNG here. So I had to do this like kind of weird stepping back. I don't want to waste soul, really, because soul is important. So what's annoying about this section is that it is very hard. Like, the first coming to picks is very hard. It is very under practiced because it's early in the game and I'm rusty. I've done one session of crystal picks practice and you see what happened. I get bad RNG and it completely throws me away. You see, I'm just like fucking it up. And like, usually when this bad RNG happens, you just take a hit and you react to it correctly. But here, I'm just out of shape. And this is just me pressing buttons too early, so the jump didn't get buffered. Skill issue. So I'm already at 2 HP. And usually and I'm already at 1 HP. Usually in situations like that, when I do an offline run and I'm at 1 HP, I'm like, you know, Hey, Grad. It's like, okay, I mean, I'm offline. I have definitely nothing to lose. It's not like I'm oblig... Like, when I do offline runs and I die at this point, I usually just go on with my business. I just... Yeah. This run died, I'll just go, you know, drink tea or something. So, I usually don't try to play safer, don't try to, you know, preserve the run. I just play like I usually play. Is this a completed run? We will see. It is a secret. I die and it will be a troll. We will see. I mean, I would never die in this gauntlet. Like, come on. I played this game for 2 years. Like... Yeah, and... So, you can make two choices here. First, you can heal here and lose time. Second, you can heal after RNG Glimbuck. And if you don't react to RNG Glimbuck, you will die. So I decided to heal here and lose 2.3 seconds like that. Instead, you can heal after the grab and only lose half a second. So I went for 2 seconds of a time loss just to try to preserve a run here, because I am past Crystal Dash. And it's only like 2.5 seconds. So you see, I reacted, so I would have survived at 1 HP, but who knows? Maybe I would have too much nerves and make a mistake. Like, never know. So faster would be killing here and just waiting for the lever, but whatever. No. What's done, done. And 2 HP, you know, is usually fine. If you're an experienced runner, you can manage 2 HP. So I decided that I won't heal anymore. I just go. But I'm way out of practice with peaks. Like, this is just ridiculous. I just need to go do peaks ILs, just for consistency, at the very least. And how can you tell that I'm out of practice? Well, because shit like that happens, right? I almost died here! Have you seen that crystal? I haven't noticed that in the run. It almost got me. I legit haven't noticed that. Holy shit. Oh my god, I haven't seen that when I did runs. Like, I was just looking at the transition. But yeah, 1 HP here, so again, if you do the right thing, you won't die. So I'm just trying to do the right thing, you know? Don't do anything sketchy. You see, I did a bit of a wider jump to not land into the spikes. I'm like losing a second here, and I'm healing here, because the buggy will just wait for you. His position depends on your vertical position, so if you will just stay there on the bottom, it will just chill on the right and wait for you to go up. So you can heal all you want. And you see, I'm still saving time over my PB. This is how way worse my PB was in this same split. I shouldn't really dove here, because I forgot that I just healed. So I'm out of soul, unfortunately, and I will lose time because of that. Hey, Piggle, thanks for the sub, for the 6 months of the support. I really appreciate it. yeah, thanks a lot. Stay on the bottom, yeah. This is the bottom mentality of a Hollow Knight speedrunner. I mean, Chicky, the way we do major glitches is if you do the major glitch, you will usually just get a penalty, you know? And I finally did the Dream Dash correctly. World record? I don't know. Let's find out. So nothing really happens on Dream Nail. It's just like, whatever. You might have noticed that I really nail inventory drops in this run. I nailed both inventory drops and crystal peaks first try, and I also think I've nailed the inventory drops on the grass drop. So inventory drops were really good, at least at this part of the run. And this is like a cheeky wall grab, so you don't have to dash at the bottom, it saves like 0.5 or something. And yeah, I was just deadly good with inventory drops at the start of this run, like holy shit, look at that. And here I realized that I don't have soul, because I fucking did dark. This is so bad. I have to go back for that fucking Geo. Oh, and I hear you, like, so current patch walls are really junky. So sometimes if you like rub against them and try to go up, they kind of stop you. And it happens in some places notoriously, so you just avoid them. But in some places it like sometimes happens, sometimes it doesn't happen. It's very hard to predict. But rubbing against the fuck. But rubbing against the wall like that is slow anyway, so you just don't do it at all. Yeah, this is like extremely sloppy early game. After City Gate, I guess after Twister, after Spell Twister, this is like extremely sloppy, not good at all. But you know, my PB early game was even worse than that, and it happened to be good overworld overall, so I don't care. This is another very important part when you do runs of categories. You need to be aware of how you can perform, like what times you can get, you know. And for that to happen, you need to finish a lot of runs. You need to be very well aware, like, of your time saves and your time losses, like basically of when the PB is doable, when the PB is not doable. And this, I believe, helps a lot with not tilting on the segments and keeping going. Because some runners would take, you know, consecutive mistakes like that, and they will just give up because they just don't know what they're capable of. Because they always reset. Because they never finished. They never finish a runs that are behind, you know? If you never finish runs that are behind, you will get a fake idea about time saves that you get in the runs. Because if you always play like mid and late game when you're only ahead, then you're obviously nervous, right? Then you perform at a PB pace, and at PB pace you usually not perform that well because of nerves. But if you're behind in late game, then you have this other mentality. You just, okay, I can't PB, we just go for golds, you know. You just play as well as you can without nerves, and you can get a good golds for late game. And you, the most important thing, you will know what you're capable of. You will know exactly how much time you can save in late game. This is why it's so incredibly powerful to finish runs that are behind, you know. And yeah, a lot of people don't do it. And this is something I've learned a lot from, well, from many runners, you know. I think, like, main people in Hollow Knight community who, like, gave me this idea are Monsta and Axe. Like, both of them are very good at finishing runs, you know. Like, you will often see, like, Monsta finishing a run that's, like, you know, like all skills run that are like 5-6 minutes behind, you know, just like a miserable no reset. But it really helps long term. Or like Axe will take like you know, 4 flower losses and finish like 106 run that's like 8 minutes behind. And yeah, it's totally fine to do that. You're not wasting your time. Well, first you're having a great time when you're on stream, you know. You can just relax and chill with the chat, have fun, you know, memes, all that. But at the same time, you also gain practice and consistency. And this was a pretty good split, by the way. I didn't gold, like my gold is pretty good, but overall pretty nice shade soul. So we call this elevator not to do like Gusten's curse strat, but to go on the right instead. Scruffy revealed that doing this is actually faster than going through the arena. You lose on Geo, but this saves like 5 seconds or 4 seconds, so it's kind of very important to do. Here, you see how good I am with inventory drops in this run. I just get every inventory drop I can. It's just a miracle. Inventory drops on this patch are frame perfect, and it's 1/50th of a second, so it's physics frame perfect. It's very hard to nail. And like, they're not like bufferable, you know, so you just have to nail them. Here I'm really out of soul, So I go for the, and I fail to fail to upslash the soul totem. And you know, mistakes like that. A lot of people are okay with, you know, big throws, but a series of small mistakes and slow imperfections will tilt them really badly. You know, it will just lower your mood consistently. And after like 10 of such mistakes, you just hate yourself and everybody else. And you're just all that grumpy, and you're sitting there like, I wanna die. So, it's alright. Stuff like this happens. You just keep going. It's okay. I tried to get a ceiling boost here and miserably failed, so yeah, good me hating. And here I realized that I don't have soul for Flukmarm, so this is like extremely sloppy. This is some cool Flukmarm, good kill. You just don't climb up, you just start from the bottom platform. Very nice. I don't know, Pimpas, maybe, but, you know, during the run you don't think about stuff like that. Here I almost fucked up because I missed the first nail hit. So, technically what I do here is not quite optimal because you kinda, like, optimally you would get one less hit on the fluke and instead you would explode the bellfly, but I don't like to mess with this bellfly. You see, another inventory drop, I'm just perfect. I'm literally TAS. This fight is pretty consistent, like... So, I go for a very particular amount of nail hits, so I always have a dive. And you see what he does? He dives. But I have just exactly soul for the dive myself to get him out of there. So, the way I do this fight, always... it's technically like a second or so slower than the optimal because I do one extra nail hit, but I do it to have a dive for the situations like that. Doing Duncan and CPX Dark Room is TAS strat. So here you just like fall optimally, and yeah, this is the most miserable hard fall in game. If you ever hard fall here, you're like obligated to reset. But Spirity wasn't watching, so oh my god, I forgot about this too. This is so bad. Yeah, it's like he was downright the worst possible situation to end up in. So yeah, like you can see that this run is not perfect at all. Like it's not like I'm gaming out of my mind. I don't play really badly. Like I'm keeping it up, you know. Karma for not resetting yet. Like I'm not like shitting my pants or like losing my shit. It's just like small mistakes that lose you a little bit of time and just some unfortunate RNG. And another important thing when you run this category is, you see how clean that is to not pay attention to shit like that. Like shit like that, you can't control this, right? And you need to kind of protect yourself from negative thoughts about RNG. It's the hardest part of the run, by the way. To not let bad RNG to your head. Like, stuff like this, especially in early game. Because the more you're in the run, the more you're focused on the run, the more mental energy you spend. And closer towards the end of the run, you can't kind of shake the RNG away, so you can always see, at least for me, you know, at least for me, you can always see me being very chill in early game, you know, a bit more concerned in mid game, and in Pantheons, I usually just complain about everything. Like, in Pantheons, I just won't shut up. I will, like, pinpoint every bad RNG, like, every second I lost RNG, and I will be very salty about it. It's just because my mental resource is exhausted by the time I get to Pantheons. What do we win if you get PB prediction right? Well, back in the days I used to gift subs to my channel, but now I won't do that. Because of the way Twitch works in Serbia, this is the country where I am now. It's not, how do you say that, monetarily beneficial to me to do it. Let's just call it like that. Oh, that was... So this fight is interesting. The way you want to do this is you want to get this kind of stagger lock. When you just always stagger him like that and de-dark infinitely. And I kinda got it here. Not instantly. Like sometimes he escapes, but you get him back. And as you can see, I'm... nice miss. As you can see, I'm running against my gold. My gold is very good. Like it was really like as good as it gets in terms of the fight. I know already this is 1 gold, and the worst thing is that I didn't took any damage. So I end up losing like 4 seconds or so to having to damage tank a lot. On this patch, it's still like no matter how much HP you have, it's always worth to get out of there early. On 1-2-1, no. On 1-2-1, if you have like 3 or more HP, you just wait there and chill. But yellow skin is pretty, it's pretty cool in this category, I feel like. But yeah, losing 3 seconds is nothing like, you know, criminal. I lost a lot more time on wings because of breach RNG. And because I got hit by RNG Molarch. So yeah. Yeah, Guston, patch differences are... Whoa, excuse me. Like half of the chat probably yawned together with me. Now we're going to... So, like, I'm really guilty of not practicing this segment. So, you see, there are plenty of segments that I've just dismissed. You know, I just know that I can get through those segments, like, I will lose time, it will be really dirty, like, and sloppy, and I forgot the strats, but I can get through them, no matter what. So I just don't practice them, because I just have more priority things to do. It's just not viable to practice everything for the run. You will always have these blind spots, it's just... the tech is just to pick your battles, to get your priorities, you know, well. And you see I'm not playing this part like to any good extent. For example, like yeah, like this, like what's that? Here, yeah, a little bit of an early control. See, I'm losing time. And here, yeah, I'm kind of brain farted to forgot what charm I should unequip and to put flukes. So I started to just explode the guy here, like that. For... it's not faster to restart, it's the same time, but we need to unequip charms. So, and it's way easier to do the arena with Shade Soul than with Lux. So that's what we do. Yeah, Maggots will have to die for Soul and Geo. Let's look at the failed champion fight. I always start with 2 nail hits. This is like pretty much perfect. Yeah, he's basically dead. I'm just waiting for him to jump over me. That's the god pattern. This is the best RNG you can hope for, literally. Let me just align some multi-hits. Yep, dead. See, this is pretty much perfect RNG. Like, this is the best fight you can get. You can see me do nail cancels on the tantrum. I always do them in case, you know, it's just sometimes you just don't have, like, you know, he just gets out of flukes with like 2 HP left and 2 nail cancels. Yeah, they will lose you time like 0.2, but it's just for consistency. So I end up golden by 0.0. So this is like the best RNG you can hope for. I don't expect to beat this particular gold like anytime soon. Or at least not by any significant amount. I think CC has 57 and this probably is like low 58 or something because of nail cancels. But I won't drop nail cancels for this, like, you know, elusive time saves. Time save. And we're going to Gorp. You can see me not unequipping flukes. It's because I want to use flukes all the way throughout the Crystal Peaks. And so Gorp fluke is a bit non-trivial because, you know, he likes to teleport. Flukes don't have a great... don't have like a good range. And so what I used to do is, like, I used to, you know, space my flukes, and I used to, like, try to dodge Gorp spikes, and I'm yawning because it was so boring, chat. What I do now, I just jump and dump all my load on his big forehead. This is what I do, this is my strat now. Like, I don't give a fuck about taking a hit here anymore. Like, I used to, 3 HP for Dark Jonias, like, and now, just like, eat shit, bro. Just look at my strat. Like, I'm so enlightened. Just like this. Well, he teleported, but still, you see, he will die anyway, like, no matter what you do, he will die. And I use, like, audio and visual cues here to get this optimal damage tank. And yeah, it's beautiful. Well played. Like, doing early control like that saves 5 seconds, so we're not doing it at all. I'm gonna Gorp. We don't know if it happened or not. This is a secret. This run might die at any moment, you know? And maybe I will just showcase you a good pacer I had. You never know. I mean, Blue considered to showcase, like, he's almost 311. Maybe I'm doing the same thing right now. But without almost. Yeah, let's look at the wiggle. I almost missed it. I corrected it at the very last moment. I went too far to the left, so I kind of calibrated myself during the wiggle and barely got it. We used to do it with the edge of the sword, but now we do it with the middle because it has twice as much hitboxes, so you just explode it faster. That's true as well. This is like textbook Johnny's execution. Like, literally perfect. I apologize for the loud sound outside. Somebody's fucking, yeah, driving. Anyway. Yeah, it's coming from the stream. It's over now. It was outside my window. So yeah, that was very... You see, I lost a second to my gold. Probably to Gorp teleport, whatever. Like, it was a very good segment. And I'm already minus 30. This is a good pace. You can see it could be like minus 40, maybe minus 50, but... how do I charge my Cyclone? I start hoarding nail arts in the load, and they partially get charged in the load. And the amount of charge, it's preserved through the Crystal Dash. So when you cancel your Crystal Dash, it just keeps on charging. Excuse me. I'm talking too much. So yeah, it get charged partially in the load. That's the secret. Yeah, yeah. So next time you see me doing nail arts out of the load, try to hear and you will try to listen and you will hear the sound. Like it's like shh. Like the sound starts in the load. So this is what I do for zero. I just get like one cyclone of the soul totem. And with flukes, zero just dies in two nail cancels because he gets multi-hit a lot. He just moves towards the fluke. You see like that. And he gets exploded. And 2D or 1U on split names is the directions for stacks. Like you pop up the stack menu and you do like down twice or up once. So yeah. I want to hide there. So yeah, this is just a little reminder, so you don't have to think. Most of them I don't even read, to be honest. I have just route internalized and I just know where to go. It's also like, you know, you have this mental map that a hidden station is at the very bottom and like dirt moth at the very top. You know, you just kind of remember stuff like that. Excuse me. Here we do a little mashing to get the dream gate and... Yep, I saved another second and now we are officially minus 30. Like, this whole section will probably get rerouted soon again. Like, CC had some good ideas to how to, like, on how to, like, put, like, reroutes soul vessels so you finish one on Seer instead of in Green Path. But for now, I decided to not bother with it. It probably won't save that much time, like 5 seconds. So I decided to just focus on my runs instead and practice other stuff. I'll just wait for him to come back and lab it out. So I can just leech out on time save. This is like... that wasn't like the cleanest drop, but... usually what you want here is to not get hit. So as long as you don't get hit here and don't fail miserably, like... you're basically fine, it's whatever. So for this, like this Grimchild is tricky, Grimkin is tricky, right? Because we have flukes. So what they lapped, if this happens, yeah. You see the idea, I was just a little bit too high. But he was damaged enough, he got damaged enough to die on the second dive. This is the strat I lapped for his dash. You just let him dash through you and then kill him with a single fluke. It works surprisingly well. But yeah, it's still a bit tricky to perform, but I mean, as long as you don't dunk and kill him in two flukes, you will still save time on average. This is like a Zillion cycle, the regular one. Pretty clean execution, and I started going for this full jump. Like, this is the fastest ending. It's really tricky, like this full jump, it just barely works. If you try to buffer it too early, you will just slide down the wall. If you do it too late, you will also slide down the wall and barely not make it. But it saves like 0.4. And I figured that I'd mess around with it. So yeah, Crystal Guardian. I just had to get hit once, you know. When he does this attack, his hitbox like extends. So, yeah, I had to move away, but I didn't, so I ended up getting hit. This is always like Monka-esque. Because if you fluke not in the right like time, So you see what I did? I fluked, I killed him, but the knockback pushed me into the laser that just spawned. So you always have to make a choice here, whether you want DPS or you want to preserve your HP. Here I knew that he's gonna die soon because he got a lot of multi-hits. And yeah, I have HP to tank one. I'm pretty confident at my 2 HP crown. You can technically get fucked by Wombo combo in the last room, but it's usually fine, you know. But I don't do optimal crystal dash here. I decide to delay it just in case. So yeah, regular room here. Technically, it is more optimal to dash away from this room and pogo the... Landon. Have you seen that? This is a classic current patch stuff. When you like land on the corner of like a ledge, sometimes it doesn't give you like a grounded state. So you just float in the air for a bit. But it doesn't happen if you don't like touch the corners. So I just landed on the corner. But yeah, 1.5 moment. It happens on 1.42 and it happens on 1.221 as well, by the way. It happens on those patches, but way more rarely. Like in 1.5 it happens, like on 1.221, 1.4 it will happen if you jump on the corner from below. Like if you jump and clip the corner, you will just like, you know, float along and your dash or jump won't get restored. But on 1.5 it will also happen if you drop down on the corner from above. So 1.5 added case to the crime. I'm not sure if this is the same thing that gives you ledge cancels. I don't think so. I don't think so actually. But yeah, that's something to be aware of. But yeah, it also happens on old patches, but in more restricted cases. So here I just like collect soul to fight Grimkin. I always thought that ledge cancels are like intentional, but they're maybe just frame perfect hard falls, who knows. This is just like a crate slash gauntlet. If there's any 1-2-2-1 all skills runners, you might be thinking, what the fuck are you doing here? And you know, the cycle here is different than an old patch, so this is what you do instead. There are like three different ways to go through this room. All of them are pretty much equal in the speed. This is just what I'm comfortable with. Hey Alolosh. Hey Blue. But you see, we're kind of still green. Like we're minus 40 almost. Like the life is good. You know, this is another section that I'm not very practiced at. So you can see, like this is gonna hardfall. Yeah, if you cancel your crystal dash here earlier, you're not gonna hardfall because you don't hit the ceiling. But I just barely fucked it up. Yeah, this is just like a cycle you have to make here. Yep. This is another section that I'm not very practiced at. And what I wanted to say is that I'm still rusty on a lot of overworld. I have a lot of like blind spots that I just didn't have time to practice. But again, I know that I can get through this part if I don't choke it. So this Grimkin is interesting. So what you'll see me doing is, as soon as this motherfucker spawns, I cancel my crystal dash, like, instantly. Because this will always make him go down. So no matter the angle, you will still be able to hit him. Even if he's, like, you know, decides to chill in the wall. Because if you don't cancel your crystal dash, he can spawn too high and then he will be too high for you to hit. And this just becomes a nightmare to handle. Here I did not believe that I have dash, so that's why I did wings. Here I'm trying to greet soul, but I just barely can't. I'll be one soul hit away. Yeah, see? That movement wasn't very good. But again, I'm out of practice with this segment, but I let myself be, because you won't lose a lot in this section. Unless you fail, for example, this strat. And this strat is just, you know, mash shades all well, and it will just work. That was a good cycle. Here I stopped my C dash way too soon and just barely got on the wall. Oh, too low. It's fine. That was okay. Like, you know, you can see me doing this all like little movement mistakes, but I usually just let them slide. Because, like, I mean, who the fuck cares? Like, this category is not about some precise strats or, you know, being perfect. It's about being consistent and not making too many stupid mistakes. And about being calm. And so my history usually shows that... So something is, you see, I have a chance here. So I was really considering here to just fireball him. But I really don't like going for that. Like in this situation, you can just dash away and try to get a double for an insta kill. But I'm just so I just hate to go for it so much because it can really fuck you. So I just stood there in front of a Grimkin, just waiting for him to despawn for the second cycle. It's okay. That was a nice one. But yeah, what I was saying is that this category is not about, you know, being all that perfect and executing the hardest strats. It's more about not making too much stupid mistakes. So you can see me slowly gaining time on my previous PB. And I mean, at some point my PB has to get good, right? Because like I got 225 overworld, and I mean it has to be get good at some point, right? But for now it seems like I'm not playing all that super like well, perfect, precise, but I'm still saving time. Well, Gusten, we'll see if I get to White Kalos at all. So yeah, Grimkin. So, as some of you might know, I've reintroduced Dove's Reroute. Dove's Reroute makes some shopping and Grim Gating and saving quids more optimal. It saves like time. But it also makes things more cursed, because you have to do a next upcoming section with upgraded Grim Child. And let me tell you what that means. So first, we have to do Hauling Wraiths. Let's forget how to pronounce. So Hauling Wraiths. Hauling Wraiths. Fuck it. Whatever. This fucking spell. Wraiths. I don't know. Yeah. And what Grimchild can do? Fog Canyon, yes. What Grimchild can do is it can kill the squids. And if he kills the squids, first you experience freeze frame and you can miss your inputs. And second, you get scammed out of soul. And you use these motherfuckers to build soul. That's why I don't do pogos here, I want soul. Here, unfortunately, I got damage traded. So, you're really on a timer here. You need to kill them faster than Grimchild. Like, you have to be fast in this room. I decided to not heal for no eyes. Because if Grimchild snipes at least one of them and advances the wave, you just get fucked. Sometimes Grimchild is fucking dead. Like, he has just like a dead aim, like a perfect aim. Sometimes he has a stormtrooper aim, you just can't predict that. So let's see how No Ice goes. I really have like a low-hate relationships with this route. It is obviously faster, it is undoubtedly faster, but also makes this section way more cursed. And I've already like dropped it and reintroduced it like 2 times. And I'm doing it again until it gets me fucked. Here, this is unfair. Like, she got stuck in the platform. But fortunately, it wasn't too much unfair. And of course, Grimchild did not fuck me up. So, it was like an, you know, average No Ice fight. It wasn't like super fast, it wasn't horrible. Just like, your kind of working man, like, you know, ain't much but an honest work. No Ice, yeah. And we're minus 40, it's, you know. Minus 40, it's okay. Like, it is 309 pace, right? Flukes? No, Pimpas, because every single fluke can hit a teleport. Oh, shit, Marcus, you actually now high. You now actually have a Marcus in your name, which is very convenient. As convenient as if my secret skill had Shelby in the name. Okay, yeah, that was a decent... Grimkin. Again, you can... I'm losing a bit of time on Assault Totem. I can take like a Let's Soul from there, save like a second and hope for the double. But it's so like... Yeah. This is something I yoink from Scryfe. I stopped doing Cyclone here and instead go for D-Dark here. Like, this particular D-Dark I just yoink from Scryfe. And, here I waited because I just get fucked here all the time. So that was pretty clean arena. So, what I wanted to say is that always watch other runners. And don't necessarily runners who are like faster than you, like who have times faster than you, or like, you know, top runners, like whatever that means, right? Just watch different runners because you will never know what you can learn. So when I used to be mod on SRC, I used to verify a lot of runs, and there's so much shit you can pick up from the runners from, like, you know, like from the middle of the board. You know, like, the runners that have, like, a, you know, like, 330 in 112. They can do, like, some really interesting shit that you can pick up. And it's very cool to learn. And it's what I try to do. Like, accidentally tapped a Cyclone too early. I try to be, like, honest to myself and self-aware of the things that I'm not very good at. And I'm trying to constantly pick up strats and improve. I will often like dunk on Janker, you know, for cursed shit, like just that does save time optimally, but will like lose your run 90% of the time. But I definitely pay attention to the category developments, and I definitely try to take my time to improve my movement in rooms. And like, I'm also trying to, you know, like encourage other runners to love shit and try to find like their own movement and experiment with the game. It's very beneficial. Here I should have gone for the Scryfe Worm Strat, but I just forgot how to do it, and again, it's not something I've practiced recently. Sometimes I do that a lot. I just modify my strats when I don't practice rooms. I just do either some really boomer strats or some easy strats. And there you go, sub our Kingdom's Edge entrance, that's very nice. Ooh, almost got hit here by the ball. Nice. I can sense how much it don't jump in the acid, yeah, that's true. Nice gold too, right? Let's see how, like, this is something I'm really, like, sad about. My Hornet fights degraded so much. Like when I used to do all skills and true endings, I just grinded Hornet 2 fights a lot and I was so good at it. I held Kamsobs in both all skills and true ending for Hornet 2 fight. And you know, I hold it while other good runners run it, like, you know, in both true ending and all skills. So I was really good at Hornet 2. And look at that, I can't even get a fucking double anymore. Just, what is this dive? Like, you shouldn't dive here. Like, just look at this. I'm so not confident in myself. I'm just waving around. I'm like, what's that? It was too early. It was too close. Like, looking at that, this is just a bad execution. That was a good up slash. This is like former me. Like, this is me. Yes, this is how it should look like. Well, not that, but yeah. So, this is a skill issue. Thanks for redemption. This is like something I feel very shameful of, because this is a skill I used to have. You know, this is a skill I used to have in me. And I don't have anymore. Like, I see that I'm doing things wrong, but it just takes... I just have to get there and like spend like 2 hours on this arena, and I don't have this time on Hornet 2. I would rather, you know, spend 2 hours on, I don't know, like NKG and got home, because it can lose way more time. And again, like, 1 duel percent is all about battles you can take. In any percent, even in all skills, you can just practice everything, right? You can like do a 3 hours practice a day and you can practice all segments. You can practice the entire game every day. You can't do that in 1 12%. Well, I can, I just don't have this much time. So careful picking your battles in this category is very beneficial for your improvement. A beast trick for Hornet 2, yeah. I lapped out a cool ceiling boost here, but unfortunately it's not very easy to get, and yeah, I couldn't get it here. But you see the time, I'm minus 50 already. Look at the fucking pace. I'm not even playing perfectly, and still the pace, holy shit. Like, at some point I have to start losing time, right? Like, you can't hold this kind of a lead forever. It just doesn't happen in this category. Remember the last major throw where I lost like 20 seconds was where? It was Crystal Peaks and Soul Master, so after that I haven't lost that much time. Like, at all. I was losing a little bit here and there, but there wasn't like major throws. Another goal. That goal was cool. Don't you dare. Okay, like, there are sections that I'm not very well practiced at, right? But I just did house, like, I do lighthouse climb in every categories I run. And just like with Hornet 2, I can get through it. Like, it will be dirty, it will be sloppy, but I will, like, unlikely die here. Like, the only reason for me to die in lighthouse climb is all skills on a very good PB pace. Like, that was just a bullshit RNG. And that was the I literally, like, you can't dash there. What the fuck? Don't worry about it. So yeah. The only reason for me to ever die on Lighthouse Climb is all skills on like a very good pace and I'm nervous. That was a shit show, but hitless. Maybe it would be more beneficial to take one damage boost. But anyway, I saved time because my PB was even worse. I think my PB started falling or something. I think I got like a good kind of rhythm cue for this early control. The thing with this early control, you have to press Dream Nail, like Dream Gate, right when your scene loads. And the way to practice for it is to enable Bench Warp mode, and it will show you a display of the current scene. And when your scene changes from the main menu to like Abyss, whatever, you press Dream Nail. And this is how you get early control. And so you have to develop some kind of a rhythm cue for your PC, like for your individual situation, for you to hit this consistently. This is how it works on current patch. Because so why early controls like that became harder on current patch? On 1.2.2.1, all loads are synchronous, right? This is so bad. Like my cyclone got canceled by the hit, but yeah, current patch changed the way scenes are loaded. Hitless, but not shitless, yes. And that's why early controls for the scene transitions became harder on current patch. So you have to kind of work around. It's still possible, but harder. This is basically the essence of current patch. No, still possible, but hard. And yeah, I got the early control, but unfortunately, because of cancelled Cyclone, I will lose a lot of time. 4 seconds. Yeah, really good thing that this is not 106 waterways. In 106 waterways, I would have already died, probably. Just like in real life, because I would be afraid. Oh my god, this crap. Luckily, I get good RNG here. And I just keep saving time, like... Or at least not losing time. Nice. Yeah, I decided to grid a bit of soul here because I didn't have enough soul from the husks in the city. Oh, yeah, that was unfortunate. I got hit there by the horn. I switched to doing crystal dash here, so I've labbed it out, and dashing with cyclone and crystal dashing are equally fast. But crystal dash is easier, and I fuck it up, of course. And here, this is second brain fart. I just forgot to do the scruffy. It's like trans dash. Like, I just lost my muscle memory for a second and went for boomer strat accidentally, and then I just doubled down on that. I will lose a lot of time here, but mostly to the city husks. So yeah, that's a time loss. This is just a brain fart. I'm well practiced in scruffy's trans dash here, but I just. Just literally, you know, sometimes your old muscle memory just takes over. And since I haven't done Crystal Dash in a while, of course I fucked it up. I guess sometimes your brain just does it, and you have to accept that. This is another section. Yeah, this is another section I'm not very well practiced at. And I think it's visible. Oh, this is like, come on. Hazel, Hazel. You can see I'm not moving, not moving well enough here. I need to practice this section too. So peaks, like green path, hornet, like, what is this? Like, I did to, like, what is it? Come on, bros. That was a shit show. Finally get double. Okay, this is good, but I don't have soul, so... You see, I don't have soul. That was a good ending. Like, ending was definitely good. Unfortunately, I lost a lot of time to one, movement, and second, to the first Mantis. I didn't get my double, and I have to use an extra spell, so I ended up having less soul for the second phase, which I actually executed quite well for the pattern. This fight can go really well. So yeah, I kind of lose time. I don't lose that much time to PB. What the fuck is this? Because in my PB this went badly too, but I lost almost 20 seconds to my gold across two splits. So yeah, in the gold potential, this lost quite a bit of time. But again, this is something you have to be conscious about. You just know your weak points. And like, I know that this section will unlikely to go well because I'm not very well practiced, so I just let it be. Like, just do wings here. Like, no. As well, what the fuck is this movement? This is not how you're supposed to do it. Like, oh, come on, bro. And I noticed here that, you see, I'm trying to get more soul. Yeah, I noticed that I don't have soul, so I try to do this and... Obviously doesn't work very well, so losing another few seconds. Yeah, as I said, shit show. Oh, and now the fucking green fight. I'm definitely very good at green fight. I think that if I pay attention, I can save pretty much any situation. Hey, Mockworm, hello. Good morning, I guess. I can save pretty much any situation when green happens. It just, you know, worst case, we'll lose you like 10 seconds. So we'll see how it goes. We'll see if this is a new world record improvement. We'll see how it goes. This is a secret offline run reveal. Yeah. Let's see how it goes. I usually not very nervous about this fight at all. Like, I just did it so many times. I know how to save it. Good RNG, you know, 4-hit trick. I noticed that I'm a bit too far to the right, so this is fine. Like, this is a good damage. Like, I know that he's mostly done. I just need a good cyclone here. And yeah, I get a good cyclone here. Like, that was very good. I just have enough soul. So you see, you see what I did here? I knew that 4 shrieks will be enough. This is the first point. So I didn't go for the up slash. So I saved myself a little bit of time by shrieking earlier. And then I explicitly damaged boosted for the 4th shriek. Because I knew that if I get 4th shriek cleanly, he will definitely die. And I had HP for that. So that was very, very explicit damage boost. And we're back to 50 seconds ahead. I'm not moving back out of it. I'm moving into it. Sometimes I start a bit to the right or a bit to the left from the G spot. So I try to adjust it a little bit between shrieks. Yeah, here I dash through that grass because fuck it. Yeah, the G spot. The green spot. So this is a change to the route. Twice in a row, my Shade Cloak just barely did not refresh. That's so infuriating. And actually, this is the split I've practiced a lot. Oh, this was a nice dodge. This is something I did very carefully because recently I was dunking here a lot. And yeah, this is a change to the route. As you can see, I don't wear the Dirty Charm, the Defender's Crest. For this, for the Dream Wielder. Face planting is changing the route. This is my secret revealed. Yep. This is another room that I spend a lot of time in to find like a good cycle. So first thing is that you try to get this aspect on the right, so you push it with your crystal dash so the small bitches don't get in your way. And you dash into the wall to get dash under the acid, but it's very precise. Otherwise that was very well executed. And this is just like a trinomy drop. You can't bonk on any platforms or you don't make the Lumiofly cycle. And this is something I've played really. Just look at that. Oh, that's such an old lady movement because I died here the other day. So I'm just being a little, like, little baby. No. This is a real time save. There are no fake time saves. Reroute is just like a, you know, different charm loadout. And now we equip additional Defender's Crest, and we keep it throughout the entirety of Queen's Gardens. So we will gonna stink. And this stink can only really fuck us up in Folk Canyon and in Umu Room if you're like not fast enough. So let's see if we... Yeah, we're drinking just water today. Cheers. So we don't have Spell Twister. We use Dream Wielder instead of Spell Twister, but we kind of like the additional Soul Vessel gives us more soul. But you can see I don't really have it filled out, so let's see how it goes. Here I wait. Yep. And like, bitch, why? Like, he was, whatever. I just go. You should never do that, by the way. You should never go for the snail cancel, because if he teleports, you will just miss your spell. And every runner that just watched that probably cringed a bit, because he... So the two bosses you should never go for nail cancel is Elderhu and No Eyes, because they can teleport after the nail hit. But this was just me being salty about that pancakes. He should have died, he didn't, he did the pancakes, and I just like snapped, you know, I just snapped at Elderhu. It's okay, I got away with it, I got away. And you see, I'm almost a minute ahead at this point. That was pretty good, like I didn't get fucked by Defender's Crest, it was fast enough. So let's see what Umu pattern I get. On my previous run that was done on stream, on my PB, not on my PB, on my dead 309 Pacer, I got bad shriek RNG, so I got 3 hit shrieks thrice in a row, and this is just the 2 slow attacks. Oh, that was cheeky hit. Nice, that was good RNG. It's just to... Defender's Crest doesn't do anything here, miss it. Defender's Crest is just something we pick up once on the bench for the discount, and then we just don't have a bench to take it off. That's the reason why it's here. Yeah. So it's just an accidentally that we wear it. But we will unequip it on the first bench that we see it. Which will be in Distant Village. Which will be very soon. By the way, notice how there is no Defender's Crest in the Dream World. Maybe there is no smell in the Dream World. You know? The Dream World is... no, clean. From stuff like that. Until, of course, White Defender gets attuned by the Godseeker. Then the shit gets into Dream World. And hell breaks loose. Literally. We only use Defender's Crest for the discount on Leg Eater. So, other than that, we don't really need it. So we just happen to have it. It doesn't do anything for the run. And this is like basically soul collection plus some cyclones. That down dash was to dodge jelly if it's in the wrong spot. And so this is the place that I always peach. So this is there's like a good movement here, but you see what I'm doing? I'm landing on, like, yeah, this is like very, very shaky movement. And the reason for that is if you dunk at any point of this climb, you will respawn at the very bottom. It looks like you 5 to 6 seconds to dunk there. That's why I'm so cautious there. Cautious. Come on, just move. No comments about that. Dream World Quirk was actually partially responsible for the bug in Rando 3. Oh, I didn't know that. I knew about the bug. I didn't know that it's because of the Dream World. This was actually pretty decent, like, room. Like, yeah, that was pretty clean. Nice. I should have cyclone from higher above, so my dashes aren't delayed. Here we'll do like a little bit of a 106 tech, aka this dream gate. I lost some time to the jelly movement. I decided to drop Shade Soul here and do Cyclone instead. It loses 0.8, but you get to keep Soul for the QG arena, and I feel like it's better. But I still do the damage. Like, you need to get all the... Yeah, it's pre-charged. I stopped my Crystal Dash a bit too early. A bit too late. So I didn't get it charged right when I get in range, so yeah. You can probably get to like 0.6 time loss optimally, but I just didn't bother to grind it enough. And I still do the damage dunk though. You kind of really scarce on HP, but this damage dunk saves 2 seconds, and I feel like giving it up for, you know, like a skipping a bench is not fair, because like then skipping the bench doesn't save as much time. And like usually it's alright unless you get hit a lot in the QG arena, but by the time you get hit in QG arena, you're kind of already fucked. And here I have to wait so I don't get hit. Just some kind of chill soul collection. And we just put a dream gate here and go on. Okay, I'm 56 seconds ahead, by the way. So yeah, we keep gaining time on average. This is a pretty cool new strat that Axe found out about. So yeah, we just hit the corpses. Stinky Charm doesn't do anything. We just didn't have a bench to unequip it yet. So don't worry about it, it will go away soon. It doesn't do anything. That was pretty clean arena, by the way. Like, went really well. We equip it for the discount. Like, Aether gives us discount for charms. And we use it in the geo route. You have to wait here a little bit to let the block open. And here are frogs. So the geo is really tight. So I just started using frogs as part of my geo route. Each frog gives like 7 geo, which is actually makes a difference, unironically now. And you get to kill motherfuckers, and you get to get there safely. Oh, look at these dodges. And I charge Cyclone for these guys. I got hit here, unfortunately. Yeah, I forgot to hold the nail art, so I got the heart fall. I have 2 HP, so I get to do this strat. Unfortunately, I can't heal. There are fucking RNG spiders all over Deepness, so we'll see how it goes. But look at the pace, we're fucking minute ahead. That was a bit spooky, I like clipped the ledge and then almost face planted the spikes. And here we just do like a ceiling boost, and then I do a cyclone drop so I can kill the spider for soul. It's technically not like that optimal, but I like having soul here for this and for upcoming sections. And yeah, this is the RNG spider room. This is a good start. I get the any percent ceiling boost and... Yep. I get the... Like, this is technically a skill issue. I really shouldn't move this far to the right, but, you know, it's hard to not make this mistake when he goes up. It's just way too easy to do this. So I decide to heal for the Devout. Because, you know, Devout can kill you, and if he kills you, you will lose a lot of time. So let's just not do this, right? I'm gonna lose these 2 seconds, I don't care. waiting here. Motherfucker. This is so painful to watch. This is just... This looks even worse when I rewatch. I have not rewatched this section, like, intentionally. This is my actually fucking life reaction to what happened. Oh. And I get hit again, holy... I haven't watched this section again. This is first time I look at it in retrospect. Like, my heart is... I'm like, so angry inside, like... That was so... That was, like, what? Three times he dashed backwards. Ugh. Oh. Oh my god, I'm literally like, I started shaking right now as a response to that. Like, this is my hands right now. Like, I'm not faking it out, this is just, fuck. This is so painful to watch. Let's see how much time it lost, but... what I said at the beginning of the run... What I said at the beginning of the run is that it is very important to finish paces that are behind, because then you know your time saves and then you know when not to reset. If I didn't know that, I would have reset this. Pimpas, I just did not I had 2 HP, you know? I would never think that he would dash back like 3 times in a row, like, this is like impossible RNG, it will never happen again to anyone. And look at me now, like, I know that it's still winnable, you know? I know it's still winnable. I even healed before that, like, holy shit. you can say all you want, like, I knew it, like, he was foreshadowing all along, but that's such a bullshit. Babala, Geno. That was like the pace of all times. But yeah, I kept going because, you know, so, I have finished a runs before and, I have finished around before and I know my pace, so I know that it's still winnable. So I decided to keep going. And in situations like that, you definitely need some time to recover because, you know, you start to get shaky, right? Like, no matter your mentality, this shit will get to you. Like, you will try to keep it together, right? But it will still show itself and you will see it later. So I decided that, well, yeah, I know this is winnable now, but this is kind of also shit, like, it's a shit show. So let's just... I decided to just play it out, you know, to just play it normally and see what happens. Because I can always reset and give up, right? You can always reset and give up, but you never know what happens if you keep going. So I did that. I got hit by the spider while overcharmed. By the husk. Yeah, I'm overcharmed now. This is a UI glitch. I'm actually overcharmed. I overcharm Shaman Stone and Grim Child. But I got an additional Cyclone so I can heal here. That was optimal, Dreamel. So yeah, chat. If you're playing long categories, you should, like, pretty much never reset, you know. I mean, I've suggested that to somebody, I don't remember to who. Here, just decided to not go for Crystal Dash. Like, here, I'm extremely shaky here, like, you know, like, heavy breathing, like, adrenaline rush. So I just decided to not mess with the Crystal Dashes like that. And I suggested that to somebody, to just unbind, unbind the reset key. Because a lot of people, they don't want to reset, right? They know this, it's a problem, but they just compulsively press reset, and they just can't do anything about it. So I always suggest to just unbind the key temporarily. Hey Jay, by the way, Jay, thanks for the sub. Like, I've seen your sub when APB'd the last time, but I tried to get off the stream so quickly, I didn't even like react to it. So yeah, thanks a lot for the support. I feel so bad about it. And yeah, let's not bully other streamers. You know, like, oh my god, like blue always resets, boo hoo, like, you know. Let's not do that, you know, everybody play as they want. It's like, at the end of the day, it's just a video game, you know, we're trying to have fun. Like, we don't need, like, a chat full of experts to yelling at us, no reset. Like, shut the fuck up. Let runners be. But yeah, I'm already ahead. Look at that. Have you seen that 2 second? I like, at this point, like, do you ever get this feeling when, do you ever get this, like, you know, detached feeling? Like, when you don't feel like you're in control of your body, but you're reacting to yourself in third person. Like, you're doing the thing, but it feels like someone else is doing the thing and you're just watching. Like, you're an observer of your own actions. Like this is incredibly weird feeling, and this is how I, like, derealization, I don't know how it's called, I definitely know there's a thing, it's probably depersonalization of derealization, and this is how I spend this entire part. It's just, you know, like a, I just had like a real fucking trauma after that devout. That was such a surreal, it was the first time ever I've experienced that. It really felt like it's not me playing the game. And I was also like, at this point emotionally, I haven't felt any like shakiness anymore. Thanks for the GG, Sam, for stopping by. Lucky bish. Thank you. Yeah, it's like you just let your muscle memory and your like spinal cord to just take over. And you see, I'm starting gaining time. Yeah, that is from Flux, yeah, Pimps. He just explodes fucking 10 times. And yeah, this is pretty much the best possible NOSCAR RNG you can hope for. He just ran back and forth, and like, this is actually RNG on my side. Like, he could have lost me like 10 seconds or maybe like, you know, like 6 seconds, but instead he helped me. And so you see, like after a big throw like that, you would usually get shaky and start losing time, but you see how well I'm playing. Like, I actually play really well. As if I just didn't die at all. Like, this is a very confident movement. This is like a very confident gameplay. Other than charm menu that I lose me, like, lost me like a second. This is very good. This movement loses 2 seconds to damage tanking, but I don't go for damage tanks here because I'm a little bitch. Like, 106 runners like Axe or Scrappy, they just go for damage tanks here. Here I dashed one too soon, but it's fine. I still like get the cycle with 1 damage tank. Yep, see, I'm saving time. After death, like, I've instantly recovered. Like, it feels like my muscle memory just protected my brain by shutting it away. And maybe that's why I got this derealization feeling. So my brain, you know, doesn't screw things up. My hands just took over the pilot seat. And I feel like this is partially because I've done this section in games a lot. Like, I've done this section under pressure. I've done this section in a no reset situation on PB paces. So I'm just feeling confident in it. So you see, I've nailed like Sharp Shadow cycles, I've nailed like Vessel Fragment cycle, I've nailed like everything basically. I'm playing with very little to no mistakes at all here. And I'm recovering, I'm saving time back. And it, like at this point you can't even see that I died on splits, right? Here I missed a nail hit, so yeah, this is a mistake. I missed a nail hit, so it happened. This is another mistake. This is not a. Here's me mixing up like Dash Master and Sharp Shadow movement a little bit. Like this is not how it should look, but this is minor mistake, really minor. I lost like a second at most. Yeah. So the secret is just, you just don't tilt, like, forehead, it's easy, you know, you just play the game. I must dream, I often dream about, like, reroutes. A lot of reroutes that I do come to me in my dreams, you know, I just think about them a lot, and so when I sleep, my brain just internalizes something, I guess. So yeah, overall, this is a very good hype engine, and we're back on pace, like, holy shit. This is, yeah, this is a bit scuffed because I missed one nail hit. Yeah, like, these are small mistakes, but, you know, you can see that my brain is taking over again. And I'm doing, like, very small mistakes, which didn't happen when I ran off of my, like, pure muscle memory. Struts from dreams. Struts from dreams, yeah. Let's look at the big beat. Oh. I'm basically running against my gold right now, right? Yeah, basically running against my gold. This is very cool, like Sharp Shadow lets you break these walls. You just do a single cyclone and then you break it with the Sharp Shadow. You see what I'm doing? I stay close to the big B. Yeah. So it is faster on average to try to aggro big B earlier instead of staying on that wall and waiting for him. It's more risky, but it's definitely faster. This unfortunate damage trade. And here, yeah, you see I'm 15 seconds ahead and I start to try hard. You know, I'm like, holy shit, like, I can get it back, like, and I was really determined, I will fucking try hard, I will do, like, you know, everything as, like, optimal as I can. And when you try to try hard too much, this leads to bad results. Like, you see this fight? I'm just trying way too hard. Like, you see what happens? Like, just, and here, I'm like, okay, fine, like, chill. Like, chill. Yeah, you see what's going on. Yeah, like, this was bad. Like, I almost died here, and when I got to 2 HP, I was like, okay, just stop, you're tryharding way too much. Like, and this is very easy mistake to do. When, you know, when you're, like, barely ahead or barely behind, you just do that, and I just lost my entire lead. Like, a lot of runners at this point just lose motivation, like, no, this run's dead, bad RNG, I suck at the game, like, dog shit, and all these other words you often see, you often hear. This happens because the runners don't know their paces. You have to know your pace, you have to know what you're capable of. And how would you know that? Well, that was bad movement. You practice and you finish runs, you play late game, you go for golds. This is 1.5 moment, I got stuck in that wall. That was just undodgeable. And this is a good RNG. Finally fucking Horms let me through. So this is me getting shaky again because I guess it's like, you know, a second phase. Like, you know, I died and I was like, and my muscle memory was in denial, you know, like my brain just got shut off, my muscles take over, I was in denial. And this is like me kind of, you know, like trading, like, no, it couldn't be me, I will get it back, like, and all this kind of crap. And I started tryharding and started losing even more time. But at some point, you will see how I just accepted my fate. And it goes away in waves. It's like, you look at, this was like a debate. If I tried to set the dream gate too much to the right, it wouldn't work, probably. Collector, you say, Pimpas. Let's see how Collector goes very soon. Yeah, this is bad movement as well, like, I know how to do this movement, I practiced it enough, I'm just shaky, you know, it's just like, not doing the right thing, basically. And it's alright. At this point, I know it's winnable, because I also have very bad got home in my PvP. Also good, almost good RNG, yeah. But at the same time, I like, you know, I'm very far into the run at this point, I can just, you know, just move along, just cruise along, like, see what happens. I feel like you're debating us. That was a nice hit, nice soul collection. This is a very nice sharp shadow cycle, just aligns so well, just look how well aligns it, how well it aligns. Just beautiful. This is not that much soul. You actually need like a 15 more, like 1150 or something. Oh shit, Twitch reminds me that I need to play ads from time to time to get more revenue. Holy shit. Should I play ad right now, chat? As Twitch tells me. Right before the cool cycles and all that. Like, and I just got Twitch notification. Like, basically, don't forget to play ads from time to time. I never play ads, by the way. I hate them. But yeah, let's see how this cycle... Like, this is a bit sketchy on current patch. Because, you know, the little hoppers can stuck in the floor because of high FPS. So you just have to react. I know 1-to-1 runners don't like it because, you know, it's harder to do. It's kind of bullshit, but I'm a god, so I gold. And yeah, it's definitely like I'm not blaming streamers who do run ads, because a lot of like people know that if you don't run ads yourself, they will run, you know, they will run themselves in the most inconvenient moment. And a lot of people just, you know, depend on Twitch revenue and they have to play ads. I have, no, either like a privilege or I'm just stupid. I don't really make any money off of Twitch, like any money at all. So I just don't bother with it. Like, why? I'm just doing it for fun. Another current patch moment, I get stuck in the fucking wall. I hate fucking walls in current patch. Let's look at the collector. Can you spot anything weird? Yeah. I was out of fucking cycle. Oh my fucking god. But yeah, so this is something you have to realize, chat. Yeah, let's look at this beautiful fight. Just look at that. I was so careful here. I was... This fucking aspect got exploded, so... I was trying my best... I was trying my best to not kill that Venge fight, because I wanted to heal and solve. 20 seconds, but yeah. So, I wanted to say something important, but it's so funny. So yeah, practice fail cases. You have to actually consciously practice failed scream skips on collector. Because it will happen in runs, like, you just need to know what to do. Like, some runners will just, you know, intuitively start fluking him, but fluking the collector won't stagger him. And you need to stagger him as soon as possible after failed scream skip. That's why I started using shrieks. Because I practiced failed scream skips. Like, it's important to practice backups and failed scenarios. That's why in White Palace for left atrium, you intentionally bonk into Saw to back this up. That's why in White Palace you don't reload your room when you practice. That's why in Celeste runners learn death cycles. Good runners in Celeste know multiple cycles for the same run. Because you will die in a run and you will have to do a separate cycle. This is very important. Every time you do practice, you don't load the save state until you perform the strat. If you fail the strat, you try to save it. Nice gold. Yeah, and in Celeste, you do this because you don't have a choice. You can't even reload the room, right? Learn. You just can't go back and reload the room. Oftentimes in Celeste. You just have to learn death cycles. But it's a good thing, even if you can reload the room. It saves you time. This is a very cool fight, like, with Flukes. And I do it all the time. You see, like, I have very explicit damage tanks and or damage rotations and dream nails. So you see, they basically die. They just die. And that was a dash in the wrong direction, by the way. That was, like, the only mistake I made. Hi, Favebrain. We're looking at a very interesting run. So, yeah, like, I'm very proud of this fight. I've loved it so much. Like, I've loved it to the point where it just doesn't matter what attack they... It barely matters what attack they do. This is just almost fully normalized. But this is not the end, this is only the beginning of the run. Yeah, like, Ellie in particular, like, it was Ellie and Violet, right, who lobbed out a lot of early flukes, like, outlined and drafted a lot of bosses and, like, fluke patterns. Oh yeah, Rek as well. It was so long ago, I don't remember all the names, but yeah, like, there was a lot of groundwork done for this. Like, I definitely spend a lot of time of lobbying on my own, like, strats for collectors and for like, Watcher Knights, but definitely wouldn't be as far without all the people who, like, you know, invested their time into the category. So this is really, like, a community effort. And I don't do Cyclone Lurian because he's the tiny boy. He's, like, you know, the big tower kind of, you know, I have a big peepee, so I build myself a big house, you know, this kind of guy, so you can't really cycle on him. What happened in Den stays in Den, yeah. Blue, if you, like skip some parts, I was a minute ahead and I died to Devout in this Den, and I lost a minute. And I kept going. But yeah, actually, like, 5B. thanks a lot for the resub and for continuous support for 5 months. I really appreciate that.
Ah, Ranjo's Denja. Junsha.
Bumps.
Garadan. Hmm, Fendazu. Junsha.
I don't know if this is world record, we have to see.
Hmm, Fendazu.
Do you still believe in me, by the way? This is like. There is no time safe in Colas. Colas in my PB were extremely good. I was like 4 seconds off of Cola 3 console, basically. So yeah, there is no time safe in Colas. Like barely any. So chat. Do you like late Isma's tier? How late do you like your Isma's tier? Do you like it as late as before White Defender? Me too, because I'm a fucking idiot. And I went for the fucking Isma's tier now. As if losing 20 seconds to Collector was not enough, I decided to lose another 20 seconds here. What the fuck am I doing? This is a good start. Like, that was bad. Ah, bitch. I know that he's gonna scream right here. I really hate when it happens. Like, this is my least favorite stuff. But he's almost almost dead. Yeah. So yeah, we're just like casually losing another like 25 seconds. 24 seconds. Like 15 to PB, you know. Now we're plus 15. And at this point I was like, bro, it's like I don't have this time. I don't have this much time to time save. I just can't throw 20 seconds here and there. And there is no time saves in Colas yet. There's no time saves in Colas. There is time save on this split, on the Colo climb though. Mainly because you don't have to call the stack and you don't have to put your dream gate as far. Let's see how Colas go. Oh, I'm so excited. Yeah, 112 really does have infinite time save. Yeah, that's true. It's same as 106, like 106 and 112 will always have infinite time saves. You know, this is just like these kinds of categories. You know, if like 40 years old Super Mario 64 has like an infinite time saves in like 120 star, like a runners can lose like, you know, 50-20 seconds and still get world record in that fucking game, then 112 and 106 will have that for a long fucking time, you know? Yeah, yeah, for sure, Gustan. You will always have, like, you know, you will always be able to die in 106 or in 112 and still PB. Like, 106 world record loses, like, a solid minute. Like, where it shouldn't lose a second, you know, like, by losing 50 seconds in early game and then forgetting to equip Flux for Flower, and yet, you know, it's still a good time. It's just because it's fucking long run. You can lose and save out of time. And I really don't have much soul because I fucked up the hoppers, but I saved some time, so let's see my calls. My calls were very inconsistent lately. So I would consistently, you know, survive in Colas, but sometimes I just do like stupid mistakes. Yeah, the climb was okay. Alright. And you see how, like, we have just 7 Geo over. That's why killing frogs is now important. Now we can kill frogs for Geo. And each of them gives 7 Geo. And I killed like 5 of them. And that's why I have enough money. Because I killed frogs. And killing frogs in QG is the best feeling ever, I tell you. Sometimes this happens, sometimes you just get a bit too close. Like, this is a disaster a little bit. Well, so, yeah, that was slow. I just didn't have that much soul to work with. Yeah, he didn't get doubled. Yeah, this is bad, Colo One. This is like a... This would probably be barely even with my PB. And Colo One was the worst Colo of my PB. So I don't have any time save here. That was good. That was good. If Pest gets 31, it won't be randomly Eridan. Like, this is a big mistake to think that offline runners just, you know, do it out of nowhere. It can happen, but if it happens, it means that he was grinding for months, you know? It's just grind that you haven't seen. It was behind the curtains. So people always keep downplaying offline runners' achievements, like, you know, it's easy, blah blah blah, yeah, it's the monster effect. Or like the Fireborn effect, like basically all the runners that, like, offline runners. People go, holy shit, they're like, they did it out of nowhere. You know, same as Scruffy, yeah, like Scruffy drops big PB out of nowhere and people think that it happened like overnight. Like he just, you know, pick up the category and just get around. Yeah, out of nowhere, like people grind for months. You just don't see. This is a big mistake, like, and you see I kind of panicked a little bit. So I know you can technically like do only like nail arts here, but I like this dream nail a lot because it gives me fuck ton of soul, and I can heal here. Yeah, Scruffy does it a lot, Ellie. When like. They just don't submit, like, people just don't submit the times they are not happy with, even if it's a world record. I'm not a big fan of that, but, you know, it's a personal thing. I should have done 2 Shade Souls here, but I decided to preserve soul. Yeah, Gusten, I definitely suspect that too. Like, Scruffy might very well be like sitting on 309 already. He just realizes that it's not that good of a time. Like, this is the point I'm trying to make. I was trying to make this whole time. People hype 309 way too much. Like, it's not that big of a deal. It is like 10 minute barriers, but you know, it's like an artificial hype. And as you see in this run, you like see at best possible time. People who've seen my PB probably know my pantheons. You know, they know that this run is like... It is 309-able with like a minute worth of death, with a minute worth of dying, right? That was good. But unfortunately overall this Pantheon, this Colo 2 is not very good. Like, it loses a lot of time to stupid shit. I decided to do dark here too, just don't mess with it. Yeah. Bad RNG and I started too early. Got hit. Yeah, he refused to double and it got me thrown a little bit. That was definitely no luck and just pure execution. And definitely not sketchy at all. I definitely did not risk to end up at 1 HP. But yeah, this is a bad color too. And I mean, why would I heal that? So you see, I'm losing like 4 seconds to my PB and almost 9 seconds, 8.5 seconds to my gold. So there is really no time save in calls. At least not the time save that is easy to get. And the thing with Call of 3 is that I know where to heal. Like, I know the heal spots. For example, you can heal once here. Then you can save some soul. And everything else you will heal after this phase. That was so lucky. That it killed the other guy on the left. And you can heal here. Twice. Not thrice. And you will heal the last time before frogs. So you need to learn where you can heal in Call of... That was bad, nail art. And that was a bad trick as well. So you see what happens. I just try hard. I know that I don't have any time save in Call of 3, so I just try hard. Like, I almost died here. So you see what happens. This is all when you're tried way too hard. This is also a point where I just say to myself, like, stop. Like just stop. Like, you see this erratic movement. I was just like, stop. It's all good. Like, you have time. Like, just relax. Again, I shot the shade so way too soon here. Because it's hard to stop. If you heal twice here, you will have to do 5 hits, but I'm down to that because I need soul to heal the final time here. Some people, like specifically Blue and Scrappy, start this phase with a shriek, but I don't like it. I do this, which is a little bit slower, but this is like very easy and ridiculously consistent. That's a good RNG. Look at that, like, he just won't spawn. That was such a long spawn. Like, holy shit, I just stood there 5 seconds and waited. That was bullshit. Yeah, they've added like random delays on current patch for no reason. That was the longest spawn I've ever seen too, Gustin. That is the longest spawn I've ever seen as well. This part is easy, you can just infinitely heal here and get infinite soul. Hey, Python. See, I'm gonna lose here. I'm already like sitting at like 10 to 15 seconds of a time loss here. That's a good start. Yeah, I framed. Yeah, I didn't get the nail hit, I mean. And here, that's unlucky, like... I did not have wings. See, I just keep losing time. I recovered pretty well though. This is pretty stupid though. So I will stay on the right platform here. For some reason, like, right platform just wipes with me. That was an unnecessary hit, but it's like very consistent strat. And you can just shade soul them from the distance when you have soul. Sometimes I will do that and, you know, collect additional soul. But if I don't have here anything, I will just start with the Dream Nail. Like, this is my low soul strat. High soul strat is start with the Great Slash. I wait for the Soul Twister. And I did extra nail hit for soul. Here I... Oh, come on, bro. Like, that was a bad movement. Bad move, I mean. Oh yeah, the ending here is pretty chill. Here I would heal twice because, like, you know, you won't get extra HP if you heal one more time and you don't have soul for it anyway. So, 5 it is. Here I hope for like a roll. Unfortunately, I mean, fortunately, roll happens, so I can do this and then I damage boost with Shriek. Well, usually you will damage boost, but here just got to my way. But like, still, regardless of the ending execution, that was extremely slow, Call of 3, and you can see me already bleeding time. And as I said, there is really no time saving calls. So yeah, it just keeps bleeding away. Yeah, it's like 18 to 20 seconds. 18.3, yep. We're plus 20. And we do a great music. So yeah, as you can see, this is like... This goes into the dark, like, this run goes into the dark place, right? Bad Colossus. I almost went to the fucking slide. I don't know why this... What's with the sound? Did I like room duped here? I don't know. Weird sound glitch. I lost 20 seconds to Collector. I lost 20 seconds to like going for Yzma's second time. I lost a lot of time to Qualls. Just time loss all over the endgame. Also lost 15 to Hive Knight. Yeah, this is not a very good run. Let's see how Gripping Zone goes. Unnecessary damage, but you know, I'm playing well. So you see, I would have gotten away with that if not for... You see that? I dashed into Flukes, so he drops down on me into Flukes too. This is a very important skill to have. You can manipulate the place where he lands, so you can pre-fluke and just let him fucking die there. It was very fast GPZ, as you can see. I say it all the time. And my gold is not very optimized here because it's a new gold. This is a new split. It's just not optimized yet. This is just like third time I'm here. And yeah, I pretty much finish all the runs I start. This is my Duras mentality. I just do as less resets as I can. And yeah, Sharp Shadow is utilized together with Dash Master. Like, this is a little soul collection I've like loved. This is like bad Sharp Shadow. You can just dash over that ledge. Scrappy actually does it too. Like, he probably labbed it out independently because it's like so... It's just so apparent that you have to do here. Another fucking wall. I hate walls on current patch. I get stuck in that wall too. Well, I did the incorrect movement. Like, I shouldn't hug the wall there anyway. I should just dash over it.
Baba Gondala.
Thank you.
This is another new split, so it's obviously not optimized. I died. That was a bit sloppy movement, a bit of a sloppy movement. And yeah, we banish Nightmare King Green because we can fight him in the Pantheons instead. And it's faster to banish in Overworld. This is a fucking floaty jump. And it got my all movement fucked. Like, and the thing is, this place always gets you floaty jump for some reason. And I still fall for it, so I ended up losing time. I think we know one particular case when it happens. Or two particular cases, but we don't know all the cases when it happens. So yeah, flower time. I'm starting to get more confident with the new flower strats, definitely. So I've recently learned like flower with Sharp Shadow and Dash Master, and labbed out all the soul collection for the strats that I go for. And so let's see how it goes. Maybe the runs die here. Maybe the run will die here. We never know. And yeah, as I said, these golds are not very well optimized because they are new. I forgot the grab, no! Losing time because of the fucking grab! No! God, time loss! to you, 3D is directions on the stack menu. So like 3 up, 2 down. This run is such a clusterfuck, not gonna lie. I mean, overcharming for flower is fine. We're not supposed to take a hit, right? 5 brain. Like, there's no difference. Sorry, yeah, you got me there. Ah, somebody else said first, I see. I took offline random non-PB and reviewing it, yeah. This is exactly what I do. Now you know. You can all go away. I almost bought this fucking last charm notch. That would have been a disaster. So here what I do is like, I dash through and then kill, but I did not kill and decided to use it for, you know, more soul. Like free soul, why not? Hey, nerf. Yeah, is receiver. PGD. This is a cool strat I love too, like you just dash through and pogo this bitch. Sharp Shadow makes it incredibly consistent and you get on cycle. And you get more soul this way. Beautiful. It's actually very easy too, it's like not hard at all. There's like clear visual cues where to stop your crystal dash. And Sharp Shadow is extremely long. While walking, it's just so you have a dash. Another wall fuck. I got fucked by this wall too. I'm getting fucked by all the walls. This is a neutral dash, very important, otherwise you just bonk into this guy and I want to get a hit of soul from him. This is room so fucking sketchy with sharp shadow, just look at me. Yeah. Yeah, walls are my true enemy in this run. This is true. I go for nice to Geo. But yeah, I go for the dodge here. I decided that I will go for this dodge until I get fucked by it, and one time I always got fucked by it. So still haven't lost a run here, so I'm like keeping on to the dodge until I get the first run, until I lose the first run to it. But saving time, you know, that was a good power. I don't know why I crystal dashed here. You're supposed to dash, but I just brain farted. Well, it is the fastest that we know so far. That wasn't a good movement. I decided to skip the totem here because I have a lot of soul. Like, I got so much soul on the flower that I did not need this soul totem, which is very good. I killed this guy instead. Sometimes you just, you know, get lucky and can pogo off the petrol like that. That was nice. Oh, failed crystal dash. Here it usually down dash, but I was too far to the left, so I did not down dash. Yeah, sharp shadow breaks that glass. It's very cool, very satisfying to do. You shriek, do like some nail hits to align yourself, then do like a nail cancel and kill them both. Very cool. That was unfortunate shriek. I damaged tank here kind of intentionally, and here too, because it doesn't matter, he's dead. Like, I have a lot of DPS output, not a lot of HP. This is why late traitor lords are so good. Fuck this up a little bit, but this is a time save for sure. Because in my APB, I dunked into spikes once. Hey, plus one, let's go, we're back on pace. It was minus minute, then it was like death, then we got all the way to minus 15 again, lost it all again, got to plus 20 after call of 3, and now we're even again. Oh, it's a white palace time. It's a white palace time. This shows again how much time save is still possible in the category. Yes, it really does. Any white palaces in the chat? So the reason why I have both Sly Final Shop and Enter White Palace is because I need to verify that I actually bought correct amount of trinkets from Sly. I had cases of me accidentally forgetting a charm or accidentally not buying enough mask shards. And also like the last one doesn't spawn. That's why I need the Sly shop split. Just so it actually splits. And I also won't enter White Palace because I want to tie my White Palace separately. It's literally possible to save 9 minutes. Well, I don't know, bathroom break time. Yeah, actually go take a bathroom break too, so enjoy the Grubfather, I guess. I'll be right back. He's moving. Hey Birdie, thanks for the raid. So, like, the shopping used to be before flour, so we would get our bathroom break earlier, and, you know, but yeah, Birdie, thanks a lot for the raid, I hope you had fun. Yeah, welcome everyone. Welcome, welcome. Patamas Gio. Shoutouts, there's no shoutouts. I will, you know, I really don't like automatic shoutouts. Like, let me, since there's nothing happened, let me rant a little bit. I'm an old man, I want to rant on clouds. I don't like automatic shoutouts because it feels soulless, you know? You just shout everybody out, like, you know, you don't even know the person, just let's shout out. Yeah, I like it to be more personal. This is also the reason, which might be a bit controversial, like, you know? Like, yeah, Birdie's cool, by the way. Yeah. Very, like, unconventional Hollow Knight content you can find over the Birdie's channel. Very interesting. But yeah, I don't like this soulless, automatically generated shout-out content like, hey, check out, like, Dark Knight 69 for the epic Hollow Knight action on their channel. You know, I don't like this crap because it doesn't feel personal, you know, it's just something you do because you have to. It's for the same reason why I don't use pronoun extension, because I want pronoun knowledge to be in my head. I want it to be personal, you know, so I want to know people's pronouns because I care, not because they are in my face, you know, this kind of stuff. This might be controversial a little bit, but yeah. Like, I like to know this thing, I like to remember that. And yeah, this is White Palace time. Yeah, I first have to get to know the pronoun, so I actually read, like, I read people's about page in their Twitch channel. I actually do that, and I read people's bio on Twitter. So I actually explicitly go and check people's pronouns and their bio so I know. And this is a very boomer thing to do. Boomers used to do that with birthdays back in the days. Before, this is a nice mistake. Before we had, like, applications, you know? Yeah, usually when people's pronouns change, they, like, you know, tell about that. And it's okay if you make a mistake and you get corrected and you correct it. Yeah, they'll usually let you know. Oh, you'll notice it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, exactly, Marcus. So, you know, I this white palace is an uneventful, like, whatever, it's perfect white palace, nobody cares, right? Like, left atrium is the easiest fucking room in the game, I would never fail it in my life, like, just forget about it. You see, like, it's basically perfect, no mistakes whatsoever. Yeah. That's good to know, Gitch. I'll try to remember that. I mean, it like rarely happens also when you're one-to-one. Like, people will always correct you, basically. And, yeah, so I actually go to people's Twitch page, I read about, and I note pronounce. I like it to be personal. The same with birthdays. I never use notifications for birthdays. I try to remember them. Or, I know, I cruise along. Like, when the birthday happens, like, people start congratulating and I just join the train. I'm out of breath. Yeah, I just joined the train. Oh, here, yeah, incorrect setup, so I had to fix it. So, yeah. my birthday is in February. Yeah, it's flawless. Like, I mean, this is kind of white palace I get when, you know, I basically gave up on the run. Like, when there's no, like, super high stakes. I know it's winnable, don't get me wrong, but I'm not really feeling any nerve because I just, you know, at this point, I would fuck up so much things in the runs that it just doesn't make any difference, bro. I just cruise along. Thank you, Jay. Yeah, I won't do this movement anymore because it can give you walking storage. I forgot that you have to do like a mini hop here. Yeah, Mars Bringer, exactly. I'm that kind of guy. I don't use automatic. Yeah, mini hop is optimal because it gives you scuff dash. But the thing is, I literally forgot about. I always did it, but I literally forgot about it because I haven't played this game for 3 months. So when I went to Durast White Palace, I literally forgot about the strat. So every time I would go through that room, I would feel that I do something wrong, but I couldn't tell what. Until I complained about walking storage yesterday and Jerome said, I always do the hop. And I was like, holy shit, I also did the hop, but I forgot about it. Yeah, my, like, I just have a boomer brain. So yeah, this is like pretty pleb, but it's like 425, 422, no, nobody cares. 23, whatever. Yeah, a good white palace for my strats is 415. And this is my, like, IL gold and, like, the thing I basically get if I do the things I go for well. So I lost, like, 7 seconds to my good white palace. Like, the good white palace, like, you know, almost dream-gated out because fuck me. Like, good white palace would be, like, 409. No. But I don't go for the strats to get sub for 10 white palaces. I don't go, I just don't go for them. But yeah, again, like, I'm sorry if, like, my, kind of a, you know, take on some things is controversial, like, I'm trying my best. And I like to personalize things. Yeah, I just decided to go back to Hidden Station, like, whatever, like, this run doesn't matter anymore. You know, it's just... like, who fucking cares? Yeah, this is like an iconic strat from Scrappy, so you actually count. You count blue here. It's very important because you have to dunk after 14th. So you see, you don't dunk instantly, you have to dunk at a specific time so you get all the life blood to count. You know, and then you boom, and you crystal dash instantly. I always like delay it by half a second, so I make sure I count till 14. Like, shoutouts to Scruffy for this strat, it's actually like big brain. It lets you keep both Dash Master and Dream Wielder for this section. Yeah, unfortunately I'm losing 4 seconds because I'm a fucking idiot and I crystal dashed way too far. Delayed my cycle a bit. Yeah, like, this is very sketchy because you have to count while you're moving and de-darking, so yeah, it's you have to focus a lot. And yeah, you know, I'm kind of guy who remembers, like, I remember my ID number. Like, I remember my ID number by member. I remember my credit card number. Like, I have few cards and I remember all of them. Damn, Blue, that's unfortunate. Oh, that's why you set sub 24 D Dark. You was talking about your pace. I did not realize that. Yeah, now I did. I was like, sub 24 D Dark, like, so what? You were talking about your face. Your pace. But yeah. But yeah, so what I was talking about, yeah, like, I remember number of my ID, I remember number of my credit cards. I remember number of my wife's phone, I remember number of my brother's phone, my mother's phone, like, by memory, so I'm that kind of guy, you know? Like, I don't like to rely on technology to remember important things, yes. This is basically the point I was trying to make this whole time, across multiple splits while you were looking at a very scuffed Void Heart climb. Yeah, it's really a paranoia. What if you end up like fucking alone without anything, you know, like in a foreign country, like getting robbed or something? You have to know who to call, right? And the number to call. Here, I kind of forgot that I have Dash Master. You see what I'm doing here? I mean, after the police, like, you know, how do you contact your relatives to get help and all that? But yeah, so. You see, this will be the best, well, the best known overworld. With a fucking minute worth of dying, of death, and like another minute lost in reroutes, in route mistakes. Start new life, living in a fucking Prague. Yeah. Prague is a good city, by the way. I was in Czech Republic once. My honeymoon, very romantic honeymoon, was spent in Prague. In 2016, this is some personal information about me, and it was very beautiful honeymoon. I got to say, we enjoyed Prague a lot. Fucking walls!
Ah, Rangers, Denja. Junsha.
I'm losing time to a fucking wall. Like, how is that? This will be like a 225 overworld with a fucking death to devout that lost over a minute. And then forgetting a route like 2 times. And then losing 40 seconds to call us. Dust on my background. Oh no. But yeah, we're finally approaching Pantheons. And the thing about my god home is no matter what I do, that was way too early. No matter what I do, I pretty much can't lose time there because it was so bad. It's almost like impossible to lose. So at this point, I know that as long as I survive in Pantheons, like as long as I get through them, I will get at least 309, right? But let's see what happens. I think like any like hyped out person already realizes that the death to Devout and time losses after might have killed 308. I think people started suspecting that, right? So at this point we see whether it will be just a pleb PB or world record, or if it will be 309. I spent entire Saturday night and entire Sunday just grinding Pantheons. I legit like played 7 hours of Hollow Knight and 7 hours of God Home. And I golded Ender God Home. Holy shit. Ah, he dodged. Fucking dodge. You see me calibrating my quick slash to the music. That was nice. I missed the nail hit! So I decided to just go on with the nails. That was pretty well executed false knight, other than... No, the missed nail hit. Yo, 3 flats are the best, holy shit! Hey, I got good RNG, let's go! Nice slashes. I mean, just let them be, Slorent, whatever. I will, like, look at them from start to finish, you know? So the earlier ones will get eternal glory. Let's see if we get gorped. I did not get my doubles because I missed like a nail hit. This is a mistake I keep like doing. That was very bad. Like, I'm getting gorped. No. Yeah. Anyway, like, so. That was mostly a skill issue. I missed a couple nail hits, so you know, it's like, I mean, I got gorp, but I also fucked up, so whatever. Like, I'm kinda tired already as usually in God Home, but on the back of my head, I just know that literally all I have to do is to just not, you know, not collapse. Like, just don't die, because it will pretty much be impossible to lose time against my Pantheons, and I lost like 50 seconds to my previous PB here, so I know I can get at least 20 of them back, right? Hey, Blossom. Hello, welcome. That was such a bad trick. Like, this is not even close to my best Pantheons, and I'm still barely losing time. Just look how bad it is. Like, <Guess all. laughs> This is like the worst. Luckily, happens. I should not heal here. This is, like, this is Pantheon 5 muscle memory. You heal once because you want HP for zero. Luckily, I got the best possible RNG here. Just look at that. I'm just playing well. This is so good. Like, that was pretty much, like, as good as it gets. This cheered me up. This definitely cheered me up. This particular fight. That was literally perfect RNG on the second phase, and I executed it very well. Yes, entering Pantheon's heal. It does heal me. It's either entering Pantheon's or entering Godhome or entering Pantheon's. No, Spirit, this is not very good P1. To, like, this is not a very good one. I can have the one that 10 seconds faster. I mean, I had ones that were like 10 seconds faster. So this is not like super like ridiculous one. This is alright for now. I missed an L hit here, and that was unlucky. So I have to repeat myself. I'm running against extremely bad Pantheons. I'm running against the worst Pantheons of my life, probably. So yeah, it's all good. That's unlucky, but I played well. Here I should have done a Shade Soul here, I admit that. Yeah, that, like, this was a mistake. I should have done a Shade Soul there and then meet him with nails to the middle of the arena. That was a misplay in my opinion. Let's see if I get the strat. Nail iron, up slash, side slash, and then two. Dead. This is how second phase looks like. It has... the only RNG he can give you is a fake dive, but it only speeds things up. It's very hard to execute though. I definitely killed the first one too soon. And yeah, this is just like... Yeah, I can't say I'm 100% consistent with that Spirity for sure. It's really hard strat to do, like, it's very hard. I'm getting better at it. But definitely can't claim that I'm consistent. And you see, I'm kind of like holding it together, I'm not collapsing. Like, that was such a good trick. I've actually grinded like Mantis Lords for a fucking hour, like I spent the entire hour on this fight because I just kept losing 10 seconds here every fucking time, so I spent an actual hour in this stupid arena to fight the stupid boss, and it paid off. This is a Shade Claw timing. I missed the D-Dark. Holy shit, Marmo's destroying me. That's stupid. Nosk is so bad and God, if he decides to fuck you up, he just, like, look at that. He will just keep fucking jumping, and yeah, he jumped into the ceiling. And I missed the nail hit, like, it's so unfortunate. Yeah, that was very bad, Nosk. Bad RNG, not perfect execution. I've practiced Nosk a lot. Too, and that's why I haven't lost as much time as I could have lost. I still was like in control pretty much, so I played okay, you know, not perfect but definitely okay. I pushed him all the way up. Yeah, that was a good fight. You see how I was, all how I always was, like, in, how I always was, like, in control of the fight against Broken Vessel. I just didn't let him to get into headman phase, just kill him first. I'm from Russia. That was a misplay. again, like, another misplay. Yeah, you don't dash here. Yeah, that was like a bad Shio. It's, you know, one of those Shios when you... It's like you do a mistake and then you just lose your rhythm and it just goes sideways. Shio is very, like, rhythmical fight. You just have to get into the groove. But losing time to Shio, like making mistakes on Shio, is pretty much always a skill issue. And here is Pantheon 3. And oh my god, I'm not looking towards it. Because I start getting flashbacks. That's a good fucking Hive Knight. I shouldn't get hit here. I have to step back because that fucking spike would have hit me. But yeah. Nice start. My PB had like one pancake Elder Who. So we'll see how this goes. He's teleported so much. Yeah, so this will be about even with my PB, I think. Yeah. I've learned this like Shriek Strat. It's still very hard. That was nice. Like, I got good RNG. Well, I got bad RNG because he spawned far away, so his stagger count instantly reset. But he followed with a good attack, so I didn't lose any time. And this is like, oh my god, this is such a I need to practice this fight, man. It went way too far. Just look at this fucking fuckfest. Like, oh my god. I don't have any words. It's just so bad. Just stop. You have 3 HP before the fight that you need to damage tank a lot. And I decide to heal one more. This is just pain, yeah. And yep, the pattern wasn't good, but I just had no business in losing a patch of HP there. And I missed a nail hit. And I dashed the wrong way. I literally dashed the wrong way. So I provoked another attack and I lost more HP. Luckily he's already almost dead, and I can't get the fucking spot. So you see, I don't have HP. Yep. No words except fuck, fucking, and fuckfest, yes. You see, I start swearing a lot because I just have no words for some of this crap. And, like, these two bosses, I just lost time to like, being shaky, you know? It's just bad HP and soul management on... Like, that was unlucky. You see, he just snipes me every fucking time. He will just snipe me and go away. It's just... Look at this! Look at this saw! He just fucking aimed at me. That's Galleon that wants to live. Yeah, this run is a trauma management. And you're my therapist, chat. Skill issues gets redeemed. No. Oh, that was cool. I gotta say my GPZ fights recently were really good. It's like, I've ascended, you know, chat, on this fight. Something just clicked. I just started to wipe with this fight. Like, something in this fight just, you know? It's, you know, sometimes you look at the Void, and Void starts looking back at you. And this is me and GPZ. I remember looking at fights that Monster gets on GPZ, and I'm like... And I was in complete disbelief because it's such a piece of art that's unbelievable. And now I'm getting the same fights as well. And look at what happens. I'm getting the first attack and I don't know what to do with it. And I don't know. I don't have soul. And I can't hit Umu because it fucking doesn't attack. And now he's dead. And what was the worst thing? You know what's the worst thing? I don't even I even save time. I save time to that. And I get floored net and losing time. I get so fucking punished and destroyed. No! Just save my soul, please. Like, what the fuck is this run? Yeah, Florida doesn't get penalized anymore, so that's a good thing. This is like a not very good slide, but I mean, it's alright. Like, don't get me wrong, this is not the worst slide that can happen. That was bad second phase. Yeah, that's not gonna lose. That's not gonna save any time. Like, that was all right for the RNG. Yeah, like up slash into shade source through attacks are very good, and you know, like, pogoing into shade soul for the dash slash is also very good. Just, you know, trying to corner him and counting on Pyrus is not a reliable strat at all. I lost time in P3 because I'm an idiot. It's not even the boss's fault, I just played bad. And the reason I fucked up Umu RNG, you know why? Because I never get good RNG at Umu. I was just in disbelief. Hey Shelby, thanks for gifting us up to Blue, appreciate it. Thanks a lot. And paid forward for the sub gifted by Sloren before. So damn, that works. Yo, I'm at 20 sub points. Oh, 20 subs. I don't know, maybe that's my biggest ever. Hard to say. Easy stonks. Literally rich. Will quit my job tomorrow. But yeah, unironically, appreciate all the support. Thanks a lot. That was a good Lostkin. Like, very good Lostkin. I want to get at least one full vessel for no ice every time, because soul is incredibly important. Because she will teleport in the corners, and you really want to get her out of there with spells. Here I got lucky with Shriek. So if he spawns closer to the middle, I go for nails. So if she's close to me, I go for nail, like close to the middle of the arena. If she's super on the corners, I try to get her out with spells. That's why soul management is incredibly important around no ice. That was decent, that was really decent, Traitor Lord. And you see how I'm bleeding time, but in P4, I'm not bleeding time to my execution, I'm bleeding time to RNG. And my execution is actually very good. So I've got my balls together after P3. I really got my balls together. Like, in this run, I lost my ways and found it again so many times, it's just incredible. No, I couldn't dodge that. Scream, please. He just won't scream. Finally. I got my cojones in my right hand, squeezed them, and said, "Hold it, motherfucker!" That was very good damage rotation. Yeah, I did the dark because I missed two nail hits, so I knew it's not gonna work. Oh my god, I forgot about it. I literally forgot that I dashed into him. That's why I cringed. I just have no memory of this. I legit just forgot about it. I lost so much time, damn. This is my new strat for Markoth. I start with up slashes, I don't start with shrieks anymore. Because of the fucking RNG that he can give you. So I go for Nailfist now. I mean, outside of Fail Champion, I'm playing really well. I gotta say, like, I play well outside of failed champion. This is not 309 pace, like, officially yet. But, you know the secret, I'm running against 22 Pantheon. Like, I just don't get 22 Pantheons anymore. So, in the back of my mind, I know that, legit, as long as I survive, I know I can poop out 21 knights just by demand. I'm already at the level when I just can poop out a 21. Just when I need it. This is a very good feeling. It's very, what's the correct word? Empowering, right? This is the word, right? Empowering. Like when you know you can do something. Just like always. It's like, you know, this euphoria that good musicians have when they know how to handle the instrument. They just know their gameplay, everything. It's like empowering, encouraging, like motivating. You just know you can do it. So at this time, I just realized, so as long as I don't die, I can do 21 P5. Unless, like, you know, a disaster happens, like literal disaster. This is not very good Soul Tyrant, but I also feel like recently I started vibing with, that should have been a neutral dash. Yeah, I feel like I started like vibing with Soul Tyrant as well. I just, my Soul Tyrant fight just, you know, improved on average. I feel like just no matter of the RNG, I'm getting better fights than I used to have, just because I'm kind of can read his patterns, or I just charge my Nellars correctly, or I don't know what happened, but it feels like I know the fights better now. You know, stuff like Mantis Lords or Noscorp, what have you. Yeah, this like is a very good start. As usual, you just destroyed the beach, the fucker. This is too, like, this is so good. Like, just look at this. That was a skill issue. Good A-frames. That was such a good start. Oh, that barely didn't hit me. That should have hit me. I just got away. That was a good fight. That was a good fight. Like barely even with my PB though. You see, minus 0.0. So yeah, this is not sub 310, right? Sub 310 pace. But I'm running against 2208 P5. Like, and I got 2118 with Grab Song before. So I know I had an IL that's 50 seconds faster. And like, I was really confident at this time. As long as I don't die, I can save this time and get sub 310. It's not free, no, but I definitely know that I can save 5 seconds, okay? Like, I can save 5 seconds and it will still be 22, you know? So, this is what scale are we talking about. And I also like that these Pantheons are just a mild improvement. Like, you know, as I generally not a big fan of, you know, having a mentality of splits that is good to run against or that is bad to run against. But I don't have this opinion about Pantheons. I don't like running against optimized Pantheons. Because my Pantheons are not like the best yet. This is not the best RNG, but I mean, I did the best I could do with this Finch Viking. So it definitely loses time. This is like a 18 seconds pattern, I think. But you know, as long as you're playing well, you know it's gonna pay off. You see what I'm doing here? I'm being very conscious about platform positioning, and I'm using my knockback just before wings so I don't fall down into the spikes. This is a very common mistake you would do in P5. Like, I lost time, but was RNG time loss, not an execution. No. Look at this execution of Lord of False Knight though. Like, this is such a good flow. beautiful. This should gold, like, this should be like low 27, absolutely. This may be even 26. Just like pristine. Also, thanks, like, fucking finally I get good RNG on most charger. No! Stop! This is like my favorite mistake. That was fine, like. Well, I golded 1 second against 27, so it has to be 26, right? You see, this is how you should dash against Gorp. Like, you have to, like, time your dash through his second spikes. That's a good Gorp. Fuck. Couldn't jump. I didn't go for the pogo. I didn't go for the pogo because in on the back of my mind, like, I'm gonna miss the D-Dark for sure. So I just did straight D-Dark. Hey, Quattro. That was a bad dash. I mistimed it. I tried to pogo the thin air because I'm a very smart individual. And this is just no choice for me because I up slashed. Tolerable. You see the time save. I'm already at minus 28. This is already sub 310. At least from the beginning, too. You can do 3 nail slashes and then jump here. So I'm definitely losing on DPS against good runners on this boss. Because I see how Day and Nightmare do 3 nail hits per Molex wing. This is something I need to train for. But as long as I know that I have time losses here, this is good. And again, the same exact RNG that's on the previous guys. And no, I haven't spirit you. I don't have a big faith in grabs and in steady body, to be honest. Because, like, you just replace steady body with up slashes in most cases. Here I just damage tank because I have a lot of soul. And I know I can afford it, so I can just heal before zero. And it also means like almost 30 seconds of a time loss in overworld spirity. So yeah, last notch is just way too sketchy. I missed this up slash, so I have to like do this fucking got hit by the sword. This is not the worst fight, it definitely went a bit out of control, but it can be so much worse. Like, it's definitely run viable, like, absolutely run viable. Like, I can't say that you can't take steady body and, like, catch up those 30 seconds. It's just, I'm not at the level where it matters yet. So, in my mind, I decided that before introducing 11th notch time loss to get additional charm, like be it Twister or Steady Body. First, I need to get good, so that was a missed nail art, so it's not gonna two cycle. So this is how fuck up usually looks like. It's not the worst case of a fuck up, but it's definitely one. So yeah, on the back of my mind, I decided that I first have to get good at Pantheons. So I need to get a, you know, like, I need to get to Nightmare's level first. Before I can make an informed decision. this kind of stuff. Let's see how Sisters of Battle go. That doesn't go too bad. Rix always does it. We'll see this graph later. Take a look at it. I go for the damage tank here, and I miss the damage tank, so I end up taking damage to fucking spikes instead. This goes out of control a little bit, but I think I gain control back. Yeah. That was unlucky. The second mantis should have spawned on top of me. I forgot to dash. That was good. So, yeah, they kind of desynced. But then they sink back, and yep, I mean, low HP, so I might as well go for the dunk, extra soul, and then just take a bench. So yeah, you see how the practice just kind of pays off. I already minus 37. That was such a good marm, you have no idea. You see, I'm almost matching my fucking gold with the bench. Shelby, thanks for gifting the sub to Rekka. That was such a good shade, so I just knew he's gonna get staggered. I just knew that this will be a stagger, so I just went for it. Hey, Brasok, hello. Match my gold, that's such a good feeling when Broken Vessel goes well. You have no idea. And finally, like, I get good Galleon too, so he just decides to die on the spot. We take those, you know. That was like a wasted trick. Like, this is still a good fight. You see, I'm not dashing anymore. That was a cheeky trick though. That was a good chill. That was a good chill.
Bam. Finner.
Hey, target full. Oh, Pantheon 3, my beloved. Pantheon 3 is the only Pantheon I lost time to in this Godform so far. That was beautiful, no parry. You see how, like, I found like a good rhythm for not triggering the parry during this attack, and I feel so good about it. That was just so perfectly executed. That was just perfect. That was just absolutely perfect. I'm so proud of this Hive Knight. I actually don't know if it loses time, Blue. Yo, Rix, thanks for the 8 months of the Epic Prime. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it. That was a good Elder Who. I get a good RNG chat. Like, it's seven seconds worse than my gold, but it's good Elder Who. Also good execution here. Yeah, I couldn't make it here, but to be honest, it wasn't really possible. I'm losing time to collect another God Tamer, like, and at this point I'm just mental about God Tamer. I don't know what to do, like, this is a good start, but then I get take damage and I just keep fucking, like, I tried to nail slash the fucking Tamer herself, it's just, it never works. Oh god. So I decide not to heal here, and this is like, having 2 HP less is fine. Having 3 HP less is monkey ass. Good start. That was such a good, but I got hit. Hit. Another hit. Another hit. At this point I'm like, oh my god. I know he's dead, so I just go for it. Like, the thing is, this is not NKG. And his balls are very small and very slow. Like, it looked sketchy, I know it looked sketchy, but it actually wasn't. Like, it was fine. It wasn't NKG. If it were NKG, I would have died. And this is exactly how I died in my previous run. But luckily, it is Grim, and you can afford that. I agree there was a risk, but don't worry, chat. It was way less risk than it looked. I just lost, like, fucking 1,000 years here to freeze frames, but I don't know what else I could have done, honestly. Hey, Alex. Clink Town, yeah, that's a good name. Not healing here. I really need the soul. As we've learned on the previous Umu, having 3 fireballs is very beneficial. Maybe Umu gives me another good RNG, who knows? And no, it won't. I will just get the sparks instead. No. Maybe now? Nope, we get the most frequent pattern. The second worst. The 15 seconds. Game is fun and fair, yeah. You know what's good though? Hell Kelpil. This time I actually have soul. And another good thing is that my PB also got the second worst pattern, so I'm not even losing anything. I don't give a fuck, frankly. You see? I just matched my PB here because my PB gets the second worst thing. So, after bad Umu, you can really get punished by Noskev. I got hit here, unfortunately. But see what happens next. I just have so much soul after Umu, and I get such a good pattern. I just kill this bitch in the air and easy win. Easy win. I like this pawn. Let's go. We're back at minus 40. You see this? Like, this shade clock was so calculated. That was unnecessary damage tank, but yeah, that was a very good sly execution. I told you. I mean, I can die to Apsarat. That was bad, I missed like a fuck ton of freaks. It's okay. Losing some time. I'm not mad about it. Good start, like... That was such a good start, good play. I'm literally cracked, like, look at that. She just gets, like, destroyed. This is, like, legit and not safe for work. And I'm running against the best possible RNG, so this is already time lost. Like, this is already not winnable. And I just dashed into him. Anyway. This is like a second or two time loss here. I just barely got hit. I'm losing some shriek damage here. So I started like pre-jumping and then I got hit. And yeah, that was a very cheeky stagger. That was a decent fight. Definitely not a bad one, but not for the RNG. Yeah, I'm on an exercise ball zero. Look at that. No comments. Just no comments. Yep, that's no ice for you. That's no ice for you, chat. This is what is known iframes as iframes glitch. This is why you heal before no ice. This is why you always heal before no ice. This can happen to anyone. Yes, if you get wombo comboed in iframes in no ice arena, you get killed, yeah. Game is fun, game is fair. I fucking like this spam. Hey, Kuro. So yeah, This run is definitely top 10 anime roller coasters. I'm so proud of it. And you see what I mean? You have to, like, you have to do it many times. Because, like, how do you not lose your shit if it happens with you? Oh, Blue. This is due to monsters. You did dark on the right side. So if you did dark on the right side, he never rolls. Yes, yes, Blue, exactly why. Yes, this is like the big brain moment that Monster left us with. Look at this shriek, that was so good. It's, don't thank me, I guess you can thank me because, you know, I'm like burying Monster's high culture. I'm like the bridge between the ancient, you know, more elegant times and the new, like, Zoomer runners. I'm like the bridge that, you know, preserves old knowledge of this category. Monster will come back eventually, I hope. Boomer tears, yes. Markov, oh my god, Markov, just stop. Keeper of the Golden Age, yeah. So, and you see how I recovered after that no lies? I just didn't even flinch. It's just a realization. You know what happened, you know why it happened. And you know why you, like, every time, like, I've heard people asking me why I heal so much before no eyes. Like, because, you know, you lose soul, and soul is obviously makes the fight faster. But this is why you heal before no eyes, because otherwise you die to shit like that. It's absolutely uncontrollable. This run had 13 flat, Kuro. Yeah, there we go. That was decent GPZ. Let's look if this guy goes well. Yep, you already know it's not gonna go well, like middle stagger. Bro, just... Oh my god, bro, just... Do this thing correct for fucking once. Remember how my last run died to NKG? So, you see how I don't have any soul and I don't want to waste any additional time, and I'm literally running against Golden NKG. And you see how bad this pattern is, like, how bad this pattern is. And, like, the thing you do, you just stagger him first to get enough soul for the kill. And then you stand slightly to the right, because that's where the spot is. And that's how you get good NKG fights, you know, chat, that's how you get it. It's not that hard. That's what I forgot, chat. I forgot that the spot is not on the seam. It's a little bit to the right. A little bit to the right. And if you get with low soul in NKG, stagger first. And then go to balloon. That's how you get fast fights. Thanks for the 40 bits.
IDFCI, if you win, ZWAS is so good. I am so happy that you finally were able to hit the G-spot valley.
Oh, just look at this pure vessel. That was a mistake, I dashed, I know. But otherwise, just look at it. I shouldn't de-dark there, like, it was just a little bitch move, but yeah. I mean, there's also upstrat. At this point, I know that no matter what happens, there is no universe in which I don't get sub 2 Absurat. Just look at this PB. 212. Look at these snail patterns! Oh, the jump! And the air stall with the shriek! I got damage here, but whatever, just look at that! Just look at this, like, perfect damage rotation! Oh, the dodge into fucking just look, this is like a piece of art, almost. Like, this is a pop-off. This is a work of a man who had enough of this shit today, you know? Like, this is just, you know, I'm done with this bullshit, just let me have it. Perfectly timed G-Dark, like, absolutely. I'm fine with taking this damage, I know the risk. Also good RNG, not gonna lie, this is way above average. And yeah, we're basically through. The only bad thing here is that I don't have soul. This is okay, almost. Nah, don't do the nightmare here. You see, I'm getting like a little bit, not shaky, but cautious. Unfortunately, I didn't have time, didn't have soul for the second shriek, so had to take a little bit of an L, but yep, GG. Got him, got him. 309 is bullshit. 309 is bad.
Oh, so cringe. Wait, I have a call.
Yes.
How do I respond? Easy.
You did it! Woo! Oh, go Valley! Good. Let's go! Claps in the chat for Valley! Hollow these in the chat for Valley! Get him go! He's so fucking good! Yes!
Yeah, thanks, Blue.
GGV alive.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks a lot. Oh shit, the hype train! Thank you! Sloren, thanks for the 100 beats. Nervous for the 100 and. Samuel George, thanks for the 100. Watson, thanks for the sub. Buck, thanks for the sub. Oh, my mouth hurts. Dragon Leaks, thanks for the 1-1. Oh, I appreciate it so much.
But is it 112?
Hey. This is me doing a side after the run. Neru, thanks for the sub. Appreciate it. I died in Beast then to the last Devout Zero and lost a minute. Wait, Rix, what happened? What did I do? Isnyan, thanks for the sub. Two people who guessed the time to the second. Yeah, just hit. Well, I had a sub 3 SOB before, but it was fake. Like, this is. Now I don't have any fake times, fake golds for sure. You see me gasping in the background. This is like I just enabled the mic to say that 309 is a bad time and I forgot to turn it off. So I'm just like sighing in silence. Yeah, this is a new world record. I guess this is like, yeah, this will be 112. So I just tell that up front because I mean, it would be really stupid to show all the run and then reveal that it's 311, right? And also, imagine if I died like to NKG. That would be like worse than a fucking ruined orgasm, like, not gonna lie.
Hahaha.
And yeah, like this is like me gasping in the background. Blue ball by NKG, yeah. And like of course I would not do Rust, like you know. Hey Martin Dahl, thanks for the sub. You said you'll sub and you did. Thank you a lot. Hype train! Woo! Choo choo, motherfuckers. like, I just can't do runs after APB. Not even if APB, you know. If I finish a run like this, you know, like this shit show of a run, you know, it feels like I busted a nut or something, and I just need a retraction time. I wouldn't do any runs or practice today, like, anyway. So, yeah. That's just what I do, I guess. I just display that.